Light? Are you getting a Busch Light tonight on your anniversary?
No, I drink man beer.
Hope he doesn't cut the cheese.
He's got the Rothless boner.
Well, sometimes I don't like the taint, you know?
I'm looking at you laughing at that boner.
I love my butt. He's my best friend.
I love you too. Is this a shot for you as well?
Buddy. No, it's my butt butt. Oh. It's good times, Nog. That was good. I can't believe we said all that stuff at one time. I'm kind of ashamed of myself a little bit. Back here, though, on the Sportscast once again here on a hump day. Back here in the Juicy Whip Studios. Got my boys here once again, Renan, the ones and twos.
What's happening?
He will be in and out of the show paying attention to the TV behind me. Watching the Dodgers-Cubs game four going on right now. I believe the Cubs just took the lead, right, Knocker?
They just scored on a ground ball.
2-0 lead, so we'll see what
goes
on.
That's all right, it's early. Plenty
we'll
of baseball left.
Updated through the show, but again, want to thank everyone for chiming in. You guys can watch us live at Sportscast Live on Ustream. We'll have the video out tomorrow, and we'll have all the iTunes, Stitcher Radio, iHeartRadio, all of your podcasting stuff will be out there for you guys tomorrow, so stick around for that. But we've got a great show for you guys coming up tonight. A lot of going on in the NFL news notes. We got our Pigskin Picks coming up, Knock. Got obviously the MLB playoffs going on. The Cleveland Indians are going to the World Series.
Unbelievable.
Who would have thought the Cleveland Indians out of all
nobody.
Teams?
Nobody. I wonder what the what were the odds on them when the playoffs started?
You go right into
my
the music.
God.
Right. Is that their celebration?
Yeah, they should come out to this.
Walk-up music.
That's their walk-up music. All right, I like it. But yeah, Indians clinch in five games over the Blue Jays today.
I did not expect that.
Yeah, I didn't either.
Nope.
But maybe the Aztecs were just a few years off, because if the Cavs win and then the Indians somehow win the World Series, we are really
Armageddon.
The world
stock
is coming
up on
to
the
an
water
end.
And canned goods.
Yeah, really. Seriously. No joke. Coming up also.
I'm
got,
going to Dan's house. He's got firearms.
Yeah. Oh, you have firearms?
A few.
Okay, so yeah, we'll be going to Dan's.
Uh-oh. That was good timing.
Uh-oh. I know.
Oh,
shit. Covey home run, two-run dinger. Addison Russell, looks like his first hit of the series.
Yeah, right?
My God.
That's all right. It's still early.
I guess see Kershaw in game five, though, I guess, right?
Yep.
Tomorrow.
Any chance of winning.
We'll talk about that. Also, we got Knocker's been in fuego, Knocker.
Pretty much.
On your
winning.
Doing a lot of winning. On your college football picks, man. Mm-hmm. I got to give you some credit. You
eight
started
games,
the year
eight
off
games
slow.
About 500. Yeah, it took a little while.
Show me the money. That's it, brother. But you got to yell that stuff.
Show me the money.
I need to feel you, Jerry. Show me the money.
I hit three this week, and I lost by 2 points on that over with the Tulsa that went to 69 instead of 71.
Tough loss.
You know, and Boise.
But you were right on
it. I don't know
it.
What the hell happened with the Boise pick, man.
You were right on there. Also coming up on the show, we're going to rag on Odell Beckham when Giants fan gets back in here in about a half hour, so stick around for that. He's always fun. Vontaze Burfict continues to be the dirtiest player in the NFL, Knocker.
Yeah, it's getting a little.
Cam Newton walks out of another presser, and we've got a new quarterback in New York with the Jets. Going to be starting this week, so we'll talk about that. Michael Irvin made a few comments about Ezekiel Elliott. He's a little friendly.
Little boy crush?
Little man crush, you would say, on Ezekiel Elliott. We'll get to his comments.
A little Brokeback Mountain thing with them Cowboys going on.
Little backdoor moonshining or something going on there.
He's a gay bot.
Don't go there. got a lot of injuries. Ben Roethlisberger, LeSean McCoy, Eddie Lacy. We'll get to all those. We're going to get to DTM or Destiny, Knocker. Later in the show, with those teams that are the bottom of the barrel, do they have a chance to have destiny and get to the playoffs still, or are they dead and should just give up on the rest of the season?
All right.
We'll get to our Pigskin Picks. I have made a move away, moving on up, people, to the top. I think I'm in third place.
Whatever.
Three back.
Whatever.
Oh, my God. Who the hell cares?
Well, I do, people. I do, because I'm in the lead now.
Oh, now you're all excited.
I'm all excited.
Right?
A 12-win week there. Now I'm right behind Lady Dragon. She's got 61. I've got 58. So we'll get to
did you change some of your picks after the show?
I did not. You can go back and go ahead and compare them. All the evidence is there.
I'm calling a little bullshit
you're
on
you're calling
that.
Bullshit on that?
Yeah, I think so. I'm going to have
to call bullshit on that.
Yep. Seriously.
Well, why don't you invest the time and go back and check?
I'm going to.
Okay. I really hope I didn't do that. I did all my picks. I did good. I did good last week. So we get to our Pigskin Picks later in the show. Hockey is in full swing right now. Our Kings are not doing so well after losing Jonathan.
No, they're not.
Jonathan Quick for the next, three, 4 months? He's going to have surgery?
Yeah, he's out.
It'd be tough. Tough going for the yeah, Kings this year. It already looks off.
The Kings' best goalie is playing in San Jose right now.
Because you had a bad day is pretty damn good, man. Again, when you guys think you're having a rough day, you tune into this show and you find out these people are having a lot worse day than you. Great White Shark breaks into this diver's cage knocker. Have you seen this video?
Yeah. This guy, that's one I did see.
That's not having a good day. So we'll get to that. Also, dude files for divorce from his wife immediately after seeing her without makeup for the first time. That's a bad day.
Damn.
Damn.
Ugly motherfucker.
Yeah, that's what he was saying at the He undoes the veil. Like, and then, also because you had a bad day, headline is going to be, dude arrested after smashing girlfriend's dildo to smithereens because she loved it more than him.
Hey, he didn't talk back.
Got arrested for it, Knock.
Talk back.
Got arrested for it.
There's actually a law.
Yeah, we got.
There's a law against breaking sex toys?
I guess he was probably in a violent manner. He might have thrown it at her.
Well, okay.
A flinging vibrating dildo could create some damage.
Could create some damage, absolutely. A hard piece of plastic.
Could poke an eye out with that thing.
Yeah, 16-inch long piece of plastic probably caused some damage.
Some bigger than others.
Absolutely.
All right, Knock. Also, shot of the week at the top of the hour. You guys can call the show at 626-208-9040 is the number. Real quick, Knock, over the weekend. Again, I watched a bunch of sports. Went down to the farmer's market. Was nice. Made some homemade chicken noodle soup.
Oh, nice.
That's good stuff for the weekend. And also, I watched history over the weekend, Knocker. Now, growing up, I spent a lot of time with your mom, my grandma, or babysitter. And during morning television, there is a game show that everyone knows called The Price is Right.
Right.
And The Price is Right made history this past week. Did you see this, Knocker? It did. And it was made with history. Back-to-back-to-back spins for $1.
Right, if you spin that wheel on the big showcase.
Knocker, that is an 8,000-to-1 odd.
Yes.
Just pure psychoticness. You can throw up the video. I think you have the video there, the three people celebrate. Here's this audio of three back to foot. It sounds like making history on The Price is Right. Here we go.
Going to start us out. Catherine, go ahead. Give the wheel a spin. Whoa. You okay? Watch yourself. Anybody want to give a shout out to?
I want to say hi to my friend Super T.
But he's nuts.
And all my friends back in North Hollywood. Woo!
Hi, everybody. Top 35. Keep it or spin. Spinning again.
Now, Knock, have you ever wanted to go on The Price is Right?
I've been.
I've been on The Price is Right. You've been?
I've been to the audience. I went to a taping.
Heavier than people think it is.
I still have my name tag. I kept it.
I want to know if this lady is on drugs. Just let me know when she wins. Watch this girl celebrate.
Go.
65 for $1. 65.
She's nuts. I think she's on LSD. I think she's on LSD, Knock. What do you think, man? I think she's on the LSD.
That's a redneck white woman dancing right there.
Yeah, so she rolls the first dollar. Now, this is the last one here.
This just might happen. 70, tie, three-way tie, three-way tie, three-way tie, three-way tie. Yes.
That's good stuff.
That's awesome. You should get more than $1,000 for that, though.
Yeah, right. Well, after taxes, are you seeing like $250?
Right, seeing like $40, you know, for all that excitement.
For an Uber ride back from right? the station where you're at.
The government takes like most of it. And you get to keep like $40.
Oh, right? Man. So that was fun.
A box of Tic Tacs and a friendly goodbye, right?
Yeah. That was cool. That's one of my favorite games for those. I love The Price is Right. It's good stuff. So, all right, Knock, what'd you do over the weekend, man? I know you watched some football, made some money.
I had the best weekend in my entire life.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Yeah, it was one of the best weekends ever.
Wow. We went to explain.
We went to Parker, Arizona.
Ooh!
Stayed at the Blue Water Hotel.
Nice.
To watch your Uncle Don drag boat race.
Oh, yeah.
Never been to the drag boat races. Got my chill-looking visor right here. This is just like...
You are. If you guys are watching, too, we got this new camera angle. You guys are getting the full panoramic view of the studio.
I'm killing it with the visor right here.
You are killing it with the visor.
But, dude, I mean, it was just fantastic, man.
It doesn't do your hair justice, though. I just want to make
it. I understand. Okay. I understand, but I didn't have time to do it, so I threw the visor on. You know how it works. but we're on the sweet transvestite.
That's right.
Now, we're on the fifth floor, right?
Yeah.
The river is 150 yards away.
Okay.
And we're right on the starting line. From the balcony of our room, there's table and chairs. So you can see the whole run, right? Unbelievable. I'd never been before. Don runs in the 10-second class. It's run against the clock. You're really not racing the other guy. You're trying to if you're in the 10-second class, you want to run 10.000.
Gotcha. Right?
The ones that run 3 seconds, the top fuels,
yeah,
unbelievable. They start them at 9 o'clock, and I'm sorry, if you're hungover, if you just went to bed, you're waking up because the whole hotel just shakes.
I don't know how you don't pass out from the G's, like the force. Like,
it's unbelievable. It really is. They jump out of the water, and then in 3 seconds, they're going an eighth of a mile.
How'd Uncle Don do? Not well?
Well, he ran 10-2, 10-2, 12, and then he found the problem, ran 10-2 again, and then in the eliminations, him and the other guy, he was number 5, and he ran against the number 2 qualifier. They both red-lighted.
Okay.
And the other guy was 1/100th of a second less red light than Don, so he got eliminated.
Wow, that sucks.
But it's just a great vibe, man.
That's cool.
Just chilling. You know, you have the pits. Lucas,
it sounds like a good time, yeah.
You're sitting right by the river all day long, watching the boats go by, and then you have barbecue.
I can do that over like a regular, even though I've been to the drags before with my Uncle Don, the normal drags in Pomona,
right,
here.
It's the same thing on water.
Yeah, but I'm saying it's much better if I got my flip-flops on and I'm next to the water,
right?
Not on hot-ass pavement where I can see boats go by and chicks in bikinis. I'm just saying.
It was just a good time. And then, you know, we went and we barbecued at night, and then we'd hit the casino and do some dancing and gamble from like 10 to 12 and go to bed, man. It was just
nice.
Unbelievably.
All right, good weekend.
Fantastic
for
weekend.
All right. Renee, you had a pretty good weekend, I'm guessing, with your Dodgers.
Had a pretty good weekend with my Dodgers. Go Dodgers. They're losing this game, unfortunately, but it was a good weekend. On Saturday, went to Flappers to go see Joey Medina.
Oh, yeah.
Nice.
So that was very fun.
That was good
cool.
time. Yeah, you said your face still hurts from laughing.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a good time.
So it was a good time. Check him out.
All right, Dan. We got Dan over here. Dan Cardona's in the house with us once again. Dan, what did you do? Enjoy USC win over the weekend?
I didn't do hardly anything
this weekend. That's a good weekend. That is a good weekend. All right, Knocker. We go 626-208-9040 is the number, guys. We're going to get into all the NFL news coming right now. Here we go.
I love the fact that you acted like you had that number memorized, and all you did was read O-Dog's tweet. All you did was read O-Dog's tweet with the number on it, right?
I know. O-Dog gives me all my information for my show. I thank you. Appreciate it, O-Dog.
That is so cool, fool, right there.
You guys should just follow O-Dog, WBKS1, for all of our information.
He's our number one African-American.
Yes.
Right?
I still, you know, we need to take a poll on that, because, you know, Blackout Falcon is...
No, he's ours. I don't know about our fans, but he's ours.
Yeah, he's ours.
Right.
But our fans might lean the other way. Just saying. No offense, O-Dog, but...
I could hear him screaming
right now. Blackout Falcon and his sandwiches, you know. His sailing rendition of sailing last week was golden.
Rug sailing.
That's fantastic.
Couldn't afford a boat, so he's sailing on his rug.
Sailing's like Aladdin. Just chilling out there. A whole new world with the letters. I'd be not. Throw me up some background here, Renee, and give me the pictures ready as we run through the headlines here. Now, first, Knocker, I've been complaining about this for a while with NFL, the No Fun League, as I like to call
Correct.
It. And once again, your boy Vernon Davis, he's still alive for somehow.
I have just amazing.
Vernon Davis scored a touchdown. Throw it up if you can here, Renee. And he was flagged for taking the football and shooting it like he's a basketball player.
Yeah, stupid.
What the hell? You can watch it right here, Knocker. This is just a simple little cell. That's a 15-yard penalty!
That's
and what happened on the ensuing play because the kickoff had to be pushed back? Right. Throw it up for me, Renee. You can take the Eagles' kick return there if you could throw it up. Eagles take the kick, next kick back, Knock, for the TD. Something's
really?
Got to be done. I don't understand. Like, this is entertainment.
Right.
I understand you can't thrust your hips. I can get maybe the twerking one.
Right.
I can get maybe bringing out like Terrell did with a marker out of his thing, signing popcorn, whatever you want to do. I should be allowed to celebrate. If I'm a football player, I score a touchdown. Some guys maybe once a season. It's not like I make a basket in basketball where I'm shooting, you know, 20 times a game. I'm making so many baskets.
Well,
or in hockey or in anything. Why can't I celebrate?
What's the difference between that and a Gronky spike?
Nothing.
I'm trying to figure that out.
Okay, so you're on
really
my side here.
On this one. The real ridiculous celebrations, no, I'm not on that side. But this one, come on, man.
Yeah, I thought if it's a single person celebrating, it's not a penalty.
Right, it had to be a choreographed thing, right? It wasn't obscene.
That's what I'm saying. That's not choreographed. It's not anything, the bow and arrow. It's come on.
Right.
Like, it's getting to the point now where you're kind of embarrassing yourselves, NFL. Like,
yes.
It's becoming an embarrassment.
And it's affecting the outcome of games.
It is. That just scored
really
a touchdown
wrong,
right there.
Mm-hmm.
And what was the Thursday night game that the announcer said? He goes, you want to know why ratings are falling?
I posted that. That got us almost a million views on our Facebook for posting that video about the Monday Night Football announcer, not Gruden, but the other guy, went out and, you know, because they called a stupid roughing a hit. It was a weak hit they called or something. And, you know, it's true, man. It's getting to the point where everything's, you know, watched or replay. What's a catch? What's not a catch? What's this? What's that? It's starting to really become frustrating. So
I agree.
Knocker, moving on here. Vontaze Burfict, man. This guy continues to become the dirtiest player in the league. If you could throw up the videos here, Renee. Deliberately stepped on LeGarrette Blount's leg over the weekend against the Bengals and took a cheap shot there against Marcellus Bennett during the game. We also saw Gronkowski get into it with a few of their players there, Knocker. Now, that's just dirty shit, right?
That he should get kicked out of the league.
Right,
for that.
Was not called for that. So then
he didn't get a penalty?
No, and here's the step on the leg. It's kind of fuzzy here, but again, right after Blount gets in his face, and then you could throw up Gronk, you know, take an exception later in the game. This was, you know, it got pretty heated during this game here. Gronk went after a couple guys, tried to take on the whole team pretty much. And I'd love to see that, Knocker. WWE match, Vontaze Burfict versus Gronk. Let's get it going, man. Cage match.
WWE.
Hell in the cell. But
if I'm the commissioner of the league and I see Burfict dive at that guy's knee.
This is the first time?
You're done for the year. Done for the year. Repeat offender, done for the year. I'm sorry, but you're out. There was no other intent.
No, but we'll flag Vernon Davis for tossing the football over the ball, but you're not going to see that block when there's six officials on the field?
Unbelievable.
It's unbelievable. Yeah. It really is. Really
ridiculous.
There was
no intention other than to end that guy's career.
Now, our biggest love story brought to you last week. I gave you guys a little rendition of Odell and his net, how they have a loving, loving relationship. And Knocker, over the weekend, Odell had quite a big game. He was actually NFC Player of the Week, I believe, and scored a pretty big touchdown for the Giants, and then decided to propose to the net here, Knock, as you can see, Renee. Went over, said how beautiful you are, and proposed.
I didn't want to see it. Why didn't he get flagged?
Because I guess it's off the field, like you're on the sideline. I don't know. Why is he not flagged for that? My question to you is, though, Eli comes out after this, and you could tell that Eli is basically swallowing his tongue here. I'm getting along with the guy because I kind of have to.
Eli is where Carson Palmer was with Ocho Cinco.
Right? It's about that point, right? Yeah. So he came out and said, you know, some of the stuff that, you know, yeah, we can deal with Odell's antics because we're winning right now, but at times it becomes tiresome.
Right.
You know? Who to you is more valuable to each other? Is Eli more valuable to Odell, or is Odell more valuable to Eli? Because as it is right now, Eli's not a very good quarterback to me. He's not very accurate right now as he was back in the day. Odell has saved him on quite a few catches. Is Odell making Eli right now, or is Eli making Odell? Where do you stand on that?
I don't know. I'm not going to go with Odell has saved him. His job is to catch the ball wherever the guy throws it. And if he's throwing it behind him because he's trying to keep him safe, or he's throwing it low because he's trying to keep it away from a defender, bottom line, you have to catch the ball. That's what you're paid to do. He's paid to put it in a position for you to catch the ball. So I am going to say, if you're asking me who is more beneficial to who, I'm going to say that Eli is more beneficial to Odell. Eli's won Super Bowls without Odell Beckham on the team at all.
No.
So he's made his mark. He's got two rings. I'm not a big Eli Manning fan, but you know, I think he's able to read the defenses, and he's able to put the ball where Odell can catch it. He needs Eli more than Eli needs him, in my opinion.
Yeah, I agree. I think, and you got to remember, Odell's only 23, so you got to kind of look at these guys are very young. I mean, my God, what I was doing at 23 years old, and these guys got millions of dollars and they're playing football. So you got to look at that. Now, a young guy who's had problems now, press conferences now for the second time after a bad loss here, Knocker. Cam Newton, you could throw up the picture for me, Renee. Comes in, obviously, dressed to the T because that's how he is, you know.
The peacock bow tie.
Oh, well, this time he's got a little fedora on and a little bow tie.
He's got a bow tie with peacock eyes on it and the little boutonniere thing on his lapel that's also a peacock eye.
So after they dropped.
You come out dressed like that, you don't think they're going to
question you?
Start hitting you?
Yeah, so they dropped the game over the weekend of the Saints, dropped to 1-5 on the season. This is the team that went to the Super Bowl last year, Knocker. As we know, last year after the Super Bowl, he did not want to talk, walked out of his presser.
Right.
We thought maybe he learned, right? Maybe he was taking kind of his lumps pretty good early in the season. Well, looks like he's gone back to his ways because this is Cam Newton during his press conference over the weekend.
Cam, you did not get to carry or run the ball a lot today. Was that Just doing what I'm asked to do.
Whole facial expression. If you watch it, the whole thing, like his whole facial expression is just
crap. 2-year-old.
Just miscommunication, lack there of execution. Just got to be better.
You can hear him sighing, Knocker, rolling his eyes. And these are legitimate questions. They're not bad questions.
That's what Olsen said.
I'd rather him go east beast mode. I'm only here because I have to
feel
be.
All right.
All right. Now, my question, there's a little more into this, but you can get the sense and the tone of the press conference just from that little snip right there.
Next question.
Yeah, my question is to you, though,
Next
Knocker.
Question.
Is Cam fit mentally to be a franchise quarterback? Or are we expecting too much out of this kid?
Next question.
Answer the question, please.
You got to find a way to win.
Hey, Bill Belichick.
That was him. That's all he said.
I know.
No, I think he's being a complete and absolute jerk. And if I was in the media, I would gather my media friends up, and I just wouldn't ask him questions. I'd have him show up for the interview, and we have no questions for you. After a win?
Yeah.
After he wins and has a great game, wouldn't ask him questions.
Well, see, you kind of lead into my next question here. My question is to you. If athletes, after they lost, would you be more impressed or think highly of them if they came out and just said, hey, guys, look, Cam came out and said, hey, we had a bad game. I didn't play very well. I don't really feel like talking to you guys right now. I'm really not going to answer any questions you guys ask me, so feel free to ask, but this is what I'm going to say to each question. Would you feel better if he came out like that?
No.
Why?
Because it's bullshit.
Is it bullshit? You can't respect a guy losing?
Can I answer?
Yeah, go ahead.
Because when he wins, he's all about himself. He's all effervescent. He's all about the team. He's all about this. All of a sudden, you know, when things start going bad, your leader is pouting like a little freaking 2-year-old. Okay? You can't have it both ways. Either you're going to suck it up and take your losses like a man and act like a man like you do when you win, right? Or if you win, don't come out either. Don't play both sides of the fence. When you win and you're all on top of it and it's all Cam and all Superman and everything's great and you're soaping it all in, you're just soaking it
so
all
how
in.
How do you expect him to act then?
Like a man.
Not like what?
Like
tell
a
me
man,
though.
Like not a, like a high school sophomore.
But obviously you're not going to be in a very good mood after you lose a game,
fine,
correct?
Don't be in a good mood. I don't ask you to be happy, but don't walk off and just be pissy ass.
I agree, man.
Come on, man. You answer questions.
I'm trying to play devil's advocate, but I really can't back him in any way here. He needs to grow up. He needs to be able to talk to the press. He needs to be able to, yeah, sit up there and take it like a goddamn man, Cam. Like, it's really getting to the point of just laughable at this point.
It is. He's just acting like a little spoiled punk.
No respect. Really is. Now, we got a quarterback change here, Knocker, in New York. Talked about Ryan Fitzpatrick a little bit. Man, this guy got paid, $10 million after a holdout. Hey, he went to Harvard. He's a smart man. He got paid a lot of money to really not do anything, and this is his stats going into the season so far. Through 6 weeks, Fitzpatrick ranks last in the NFL in completion percentage at 57. Last interceptions with 11 already. That's an average of almost 2 a game.
Wow.
Passer rating of 63, Knocker. His 11 turnovers are more than 26 teams have committed this season combined. Okay?
Wow.
Yeah, ridiculous. And Fitzpatrick has basically been dreadful in the second half with 1 TD to 10 interceptions. That's your $10 million quarterback.
What?
He's a thief. He did the best heist in all of football. He really did.
That's awesome.
That I don't know whether awesome. The man to hate the man or just be like,
I'm proud of him.
I'm proud of you, Fitzy.
You got these idiots.
You took that education. You made yourself $10 million off a couple good games last year. Hey.
More power to you.
More power to you.
Donald Trump says, man. Just makes him smart.
So the Jets are going to rely on Geno Smith once again. Let's hope he doesn't get punched in the face by a player for lending money.
Geno.
Yeah.
Geno, all I needed was a field goal or something to win my pool, man. You guys, 3 points?
Couldn't do it for you, man.
3 points?
Couldn't do it for
3 points in an entire football game. You scored 3 points. Unbelievable.
Pretty sad.
It's pretty disgusting.
Sad. Now Knocker.
You're a worthless piece of shit.
Well, we know what Knocker thinks. Michael Irvin had some comments to say over the week, Knocker, about Ezekiel Elliott, who is right now having a pretty spectacular rookie season for my Dallas Cowboys. Now, He came out. He's been known and to have to say stuff that's maybe off the cuff, would you say? Maybe out there. He's
yeah, a little
sketchy past. Yeah. He's had his fair share of party.
Sure.
Now, Ezekiel, he was asked about Ezekiel Elliott over the weekend on a radio station, 103.5 The Fan in Dallas, what his thoughts were about Ezekiel's performance up to this point. And he had this to say, Renee, if you could just give me some volume here. Here we go.
He said, man, you know, fourth quarter, we get a lead. It's just about pounding people into submission. I'm like, man, dude, I'm telling you, man, when I listen to this boy talk about running the football like that, it just makes me want to go in the bathroom and spend some time by myself. You
Whoa!
Know, I just love it. So, wait,
what was that? Wait, I want to rewind here. Here we go.
Mission. I'm like, man, dude, I'm telling you, man, when I listen to this boy talk about running the football like that, boy, it just makes me want to go in the bathroom and spend some time by myself. You
Whoa!
Know, I just love it so much. Yeah, you know, them young days.
We are all excited. I understand.
B-Knock. You ever felt that way about someone or an athlete?
No.
Okay.
Well, Kornikova was kind of nice.
Guilty.
No, I said Kornikova. That's a girl.
I was playing that for Michael.
Oh, okay.
a little too much information.
Anna Kornikova was pretty special, right?
Pretty special.
She was pretty spectacular. She was not very good at tennis, but did not care. But Michael Irvin, you could save those details. You really don't have to share those with
right?
us. We don't need to know how much
Just
you
say
love.
It gets you pumped up and move on.
I like turtles.
I bet you do. All right, Naka. Lastly, to finish off before we go to break here, some injuries. Give me your thoughts here. Ben Roethlisberger suffered an injury last week. I think you got a couple pictures here, Renee. Getting walked into a locker room during the game last week against the Dolphins, who just manhandled the Steelers last week. Now it looks like he's going to be out 4 to 6 weeks here, Naka, for surgery to repair the torn meniscus in his left knee. Looks like the quarterback for them is going to be out. Knocker, they go to face the Patriots this week. How bad a blow is this to the Steelers? And is there anybody right now? Because I thought the Steelers were that can take down the Patriots. Because for me, it's just another walk to the seventh Super Bowl for Brady.
I agree. Right now, there's nobody in the AFC that can compare to the Patriots.
I mean, Landry Jones isn't that bad, but he's not Ben Roethlisberger.
No. And the Steelers are in big, fat trouble.
And you got Brady coming into Steelersville next week. It's going to be a good one. Next here, LeSean McCoy had a huge game last week for the Bills, but it looks like he might be out this
week.
That
was ugly.
Looks like his hamstring was tight. He will be checked by the medical staff today during practice. They're not sure the severity of the injury, but we'll have to stay close eye on it because that looked pretty nasty last week. I was surprised he came back into the game. First of all, well, after
for
that.
Real, I thought his leg was broken.
And,
I really did.
So LeSean McCoy, check on him with his hamstring. And lastly here, it gets worse and worse for the Packers, not only losing games and their quarterback has a controversy as far as his attitude goes, but now they're going to be without their running back, Eddie Lacy, going to be out for an unknown amount of time with an ankle and foot injury. Their backup, James Starks, is already out with a knee injury. Their backup to there, Demarius Randall, is already out. And their backup to him, Quentin Rollins, is out, Knocker. So who'd they go get? Niles Davis from the Chiefs.
Niles Davis.
Your big fantasy football pickup of the week. He's going to be starting for the Packers here.
Of course, I had Starks on my team. And Jeremy Hill.
Yeah.
I'm in good shape.
You're looking good.
I'm in good. And Roethlisberger was my quarterback.
You played Pepsters over the weekend, didn't you?
I'm not sure who I played. I think
you played Pepsters. Did you
beat him? Thank God for the Arizona running back, man.
Yeah, David Johnson's just been...
I mean,
phenomenal.
I only had like 4 players score points, and I still won.
Phenomenal. All right, here we go. Really? Oh, my God.
Seriously, man.
All right, let's go to break here, Renee. When we get back, guys, get to our Pigskin Pick'ems week. What is it? Week 7?
6.
No, 7. We're in week 7.
7,
yeah. We're in week 7 here. Get to our Pigskin Pick'ems. Go over the leaderboard. A little DTM or Destiny. We're going to go over the bottom tier teams here. Let you guys know if we think they got a future to make the playoffs. So let's just kill them off now and get it over with. Shot of the week, Tim Tebow getting his first hit knock. Anything special?
No.
Okay, me neither. I didn't think so. We'll be back after this.
Again, spread the word, rate the show, leave a review. It always helps out. Again, please check out our SoundCloud as well. Subscribe to that. For all you guys with the iHeartRadio app, you can find us on the iHeartRadio channel. Just search Sportscast. Also on our YouTube channel. I believe that's my phone with Chewy going off right now. Also, guys, we're going to have, again, video up on YouTube for you guys. Please tell a friend, spread the word. We really appreciate it. And also support our sponsors, Fireman's Brew, official beer sponsor of the show. We've got the fridge packed right there of the menage a trois of beers, guys. Firemansbrew.com, Fireman's Brew on Twitter and on Facebook and on Instagram. Again, when you guys buy their beer, a portion of it goes to help out fallen firefighters' families. So, again, yes. Not only are you enjoying great beer, but you're helping a good cause. So,
yep.
Firemansbrew.com, guys, today, official beer sponsor of the show. All right, Knock. We haven't played this game in a little while here, and I brought it back up just because I think it's a good time. Now, we're, what, again, 7 weeks into the season, right?
Yes.
So we kind of got a feel of who's good, who's not, who kind of maybe going to make the playoffs. I think it's time to just bury some teams.
Yes.
Time to play some DTM or Destiny. These teams dead, or they have any life left in to come make a playoff run. All right? So we're going to go through the bottom tier teams before we get to our Pigskin
Pick'ems. By the way, Blackout Drunk Falcon chimes in. Evening, gentlemen.
Oh, evening. Evening.
Evening, Blackout.
Sailing to you, sir. Sailing to you. We'll play it later for you in the show. We'll play it later. All right, Knocker, let's play a little bit of...
DTM, right. Your Destiny.
That's so good.
Kenny, hello.
Kenny,
it,
man.
Kenny, I miss you.
Cripple Kenny, we love you, brother. That was just a drop made by... I think this might be like our second drop ever on the
yes.
show.
That was like week two.
That was just good stuff. One more time. I haven't heard that already.
DTM or Destiny.
My favorite one.
Destiny. I like the echo. I like the echo. In the...
Destiny. My favorite one is still Power Rangers. Power
oh, God. Rangers. Do we have that even? Do I even have that?
You've
in
played
the...
it before.
Do I even go? I don't even know if I have that. I think Renee's got it somewhere over there. But
oh, somebody's got it. I have it. It cannot be lost.
No, I have it. I have it. Knocker somewhere. I'll find it. But all right, let's get it. DTM or Destiny. Throw them a little bit. It's getting hot in here. Do you have that one? Just to see a little fire. Who's going down? All right, B-Knock, first up here. I'm either going to give him a gunshot or a ding, depending on what you do, all right?
Yep.
All right, first up here, Knocker, is the Chargers. That team right now, their plus-minus points scored is actually in the plus. They've scored more points than they've given up, lost a lot of games in the last second of the game here, but it's a bad coaching call, bad snap, bad hold. They're 2-4. Now, with the Denver loss last week, you got the Raiders falling down a little bit back into the pack. Do the Chargers, DTM or Destiny to you? Should we just kill them now, bury them? Are they done? No chance to make the playoffs, or you still see some light there in the Chargers?
God, I don't know. That's really, really a tough one.
It is, but you got to make a decision.
The way the league is going right now, 8-8 might make the playoffs.
Right, not AFC card, especially.
Right? I mean, I don't think they can win the division. I don't see that, but if you finish 8-8,
if there's any chance you let him have Destiny.
Squeak in.
So no barium. What are you doing?
God, I'd love to see their schedule, but just on the surface, I'm gonna have to give a DTM.
Oh, multiple shots, double tapping him.
Sorry, man.
Damn. All right, Chargers are buried. Knocker, I'm with you. I'm gonna bury the Chargers as well. Just too many injuries on both sides of the ball.
Right.
They're playing a little better than they should actually. They've got a pretty good matchup this week, but I'm going to put them down. I don't think they can recover from the slow start. Next up here, Knocker, Andrew Luck of the Colts.
Wow.
About to win the AFC South here, but now they're 2-4 dropping that. I can't believe they lost that game against the Texans on Sunday night.
That was brutal.
Absolutely disgusting.
That was brutal.
Luck says the right stuff in the press conference, but you know what, Luck? Just come out and say, my team sucks. I'm sick of getting hit because I'm sick of saying, oh, it's my fault, 90 per practice. No, you're really good, and everyone else sucks around you. They're 2-4. You got the Texans now at 4-2, lead that division. The Jags playing a little better. Do you see the Colts somehow getting in the playoffs, or should we just bury them and start thinking about 2017-18?
Well, I think they have a problem because in that last game, when they got the ball back, protecting the 7-point lead, totally and completely unimaginative play calls from their offensive coordinator. And you know, you have to understand, if you're the offensive coordinator for the Colts, your defense sucks. Your defense really sucks.
Yep.
You needed to win that game on offense. You needed to do whatever you needed to do to get a first down, and I don't think he was thinking that way. I think they have a huge issue with the defense. I think that division with Jacksonville coming on a little stronger.
Titans are playing well,
right?
Too.
Titans playing well. I think they're
going
to finish.
Yes or no, let's go.
I think they're going to finish 6-10, and they're not going to get there.
All right, I'm with you too, Knock. I'm going to put them dead in the ground. I'm going to go ahead and shoot the Colts here because if you look at their schedule right now, Knock, they got to play the Titans coming up this week, a tough game. Then they got to go play the Chiefs, the Packers, the Titans, the Steelers, the Jets, the Texans, and the Vikings. Back to those are tough games. I don't see him coming out with that and winning even half of those. So,
Dan, you got an opinion on that?
Yeah, Colts.
No opinion on
Colts playoffs.
I just don't think they've been doing it anywhere around on any side of the ball.
Yeah,
it just looks like a hot mess.
It's a bad team.
It is.
Well, there's a hot mess going on in Chicago. Not talking about the Cubs, but the Bears, man. Jay Cutler's playing. Bears are 1-5,
Not
Knocker.
Bears.
Can we just put them in the ground for the season?
Oh, absolutely. They're going for the number one draft pick.
Just unload the gun.
Watson,
all right,
Watson will probably end up there.
All right.
The kid from Louisville.
All right. So we buried our first three teams.
Yes.
We don't have a destiny yet in these first three teams.
No,
all right.
We don't.
Next up here, the Jags at 2-3, Knocker. Picking up a couple wins the last few weeks here. Now 2-3. They're looking to get their passing game going. I still hate Yeldon. He's a piece of shit in fantasy. Doesn't do anything. But Allen Hurns and Robinson are fantastic receivers. He really pissed me off, Knocker. He pissed me so bad. So if I saw him in a bar, I'm not a violent man. I might put a booger in his food, like, or something, you know?
Wet Willie.
Just
something.
But put an atomic pepper like Dumb and Dumber and watch him just freak out. Pills are good. So, Knock, Jags at 2-3. Jags at 2-3 here, Knock. What are you going to do with the Jags? I'm going to give you their upcoming schedule. They got Raiders, Titans, Chiefs, Texans, Lions, and Bills coming up.
Ooh, I think they split those. I think they have a shot at 9-7, and 9-7 puts them in the playoffs. I'm going to give them a little.
You're
going to
keep the
right
Jags
here.
In?
I think so. The games that they've lost have been fairly close. They haven't been blown out. They're building a little bit of momentum down there. Okay. I think they have a chance to be 9-7.
All right, I'm going to go ahead and kill off yet another team. Wow. The Jags will not make the playoffs because they're the Jags. All right, next up, Panthers at 1-5, Knocker. This team was in the Super Bowl last
year.
Yes,
they were.
Now they're 1-5. Their quarterback can't seem to just hold it together mentally. Are we shooting another one? Are we
Hell
taking them
yeah.
out? Oh, my God.
Hell just, yeah. Bury them.
We're just running through these teams here.
Bury
them. Oh, we're loading up the shotgun now. All right, Knock. Next up here, Saints at 2-3, B-Knock. Showed some life with the win last week over
Very
the
nice
Panthers.
Win. Very nice win.
And Drew Brees and company seems to might still have. He's throwing big numbers again, Drew Brees. At 2-3, that NFC kind of still may be up for grabs there. The Falcons are pulling away a little bit, but they, hey, I'm
Falcons
not still believing.
Falcons.
The Falcons are the Falcons. I love you, Blackout, but they're the Falcons, all right? Now, B-Knock, what do you got here on them? What are you going to say?
Hey, why not, man? Why not? You know, Drew Brees is still Drew Brees. They're putting up points. They can shore up their defense a little. Their division isn't all that strong. So, yeah, I think they had a shot at it. I'm not going to bury them just yet. Talk to me in 3 weeks.
I'm not going to bury them yet, even though they've got a couple tough games. They've got to play the Chiefs, the Seahawks, but then they get the Niners, the Broncos, a depleted Panthers right. team, the Rams, the Lions, the Bucks. So right. They could go on a little bit of a run there.
Yeah.
And again, they control their own destiny by playing the Bucks and the Falcons to finish off the season. So,
yeah,
you know,
yeah,
you're looking
that's
at there.
Not a bad.
You know what? I'm with you. I'm going to keep the Saints in. I'm with you. I like the Saints there. My first team. All right, Knock. Next up here, the 49ers at 1-5.
They were dead before they
okay.
flipped their first coin.
Okay, yeah. Hiroshima, the fucking 49ers.
Wow.
Keep that ready to go, all right? Keep that ready to go. Next up here, Knock, your team in L.A., they started off a little rough, then picked it up, and now they've fallen a little bit. The Rams at 3-3 here. I like Case Keenum. He's actually having a pretty decent season. Like the running game. Their defense is fantastic, especially their defensive line. At 3-3 here, Knocker, Rams, DTM, or Destiny, what do you got?
Give me their schedule.
Let me get their schedule here real quick. Their schedule is going to be...
And then they go to London and play the Giants.
Yeah, they got to play in London this week against the Giants. Then they're going to get the Panthers at home. The Rams at home, that is. They're going to be away to the Jets, then at home to the Dolphins, away to the Saints, away to the Patriots, Falcons, Seahawks, 49ers, Cardinals.
Playoffs, baby.
You're going playoffs?
Playoffs, baby.
For the Rams?
Yeah.
I never believed it when it happened. Kill them off, drop Hiroshima on the Rams. There we go. All right, so my only team is the Saints
so
far.
That sounds like my post-burrito morning right there.
That's what it sounds like in the toilet.
That's the Alberto's 2 o'clock run right there.
That's the manual special.
Shouldn't have got the super nachos, I swear to God. All right, next up here, Knocker. This team is known for failures, but they're playing kind of well. The Lions at 3-3 here, Knocker. DTM or Destiny with Detroit. They're playing all right here, but they got the Vikings in the division. But can they sneak into the wild card? Their schedule is real quick. At home against the Redskins, at Texans, at Vikings, at home against the Jags, at home against the Vikings, at Saints, Bears, Giants, Cowboys, Packers.
No, the Bears and the Giants are the only games I see them with a real good shot of winning. No.
Yeah, I'm with you. Drop the bomb on Lions, baby. Drop the Hiroshima.
Los Leones.
Los Leones. Fantastic.
It's like Tropic Thunder.
I know. All right, B-Knock. Last three teams here before we get to pickups. Bengals at 2-4. Team to have the best roster in all of football, but again, they become the Bengals and never can put it together. Andy Dalton, the Red Rider BB gun, once again continues to disappoint. AJ Green banged up once again. Where do you see the Bengals going? DTM or Destiny at 2-4 right now. They play the Browns, the Redskins, the Giants, the Bills, the Ravens, Eagles, Browns, Steelers, Texans, and Ravens.
Wow. That's a pretty easy schedule.
Right now. And again, you got Pittsburgh at 4-2 without Big Ben here.
God, I hate to say this.
They're just gonna
don't
just...
bury him. Don't. Are you gonna bury him?
No, I'm not.
They're mine. I don't like
but
it.
I know they're not gonna make it. I know, but I'm not going to.
I'm with you. I'm really gonna shoot myself for this one. Literally, with the Red Ryder BB gun, will shoot me.
I'm so wrong on this. But
me
yes,
too.
I
I'm gonna
give him
just
destiny.
Yeah. You can't just see it. We're gonna be back here in 4 weeks, being like, my God,
what the hell are we thinking?
Seriously. All right, idiot. Nox. I've saved the Saints and Bengals so far. So, two teams left. The Dolphins at 2-4, Knocker, come up with the upset against the Steelers last week. That tough division with Brady. The Bills are still going. Yeah, drop the bomb on the Dolphins. My God.
I'm not even going to waste breath on that.
You know what? That's Ryan Tannehill's weaponry right there. His wife. That's her. All right, lastly here, the Titans at 3-3, Knocker. Had a pretty decent season so far for a team that wasn't expecting much. Titans at 3-3. That division is, again, wide open with the Texans and the Colts, both kind of struggling here or there, and I don't really believe in either of them. Are we saving the Titans? Lastly here.
I think they're a year away. No.
You're going to drop the bomb?
I think they're 1 year away.
Drop the bomb on the Titans! We just decimated a lot of fan seasons right now that are listening to this
Trump
show.
Nuclear on
yeah, we went nuclear right Trump. There. We just pushed the button like Trump. He's like, push, 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 push.
I bombed the hell out of him.
So, Knocker, I'm saving the Saints and the Bengals as far as my teams go, and you're saving the Jags, the Saints, and the Bengals.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Okay, the other ones we have blessed. All right, here we go. All right, let's
None
get into it.
None of those teams are playing exciting football to even watch.
I know.
Right. I didn't say I was excited about it.
I mean, it's just, there's nothing there. It's,
right? Would not pay to see any one of those Philly teams play.
I would not. You know what? I would not see to pay.
And you know what? I think that's what's wrong with the ratings. The timeouts and the, you know, dudes, okay, can we just go with this? I'm sorry, Josh, I'm going on a little thing here. Can we just do this? Can we just, on a kickoff, right, score a touchdown, kick the extra point?
Yeah.
Can we just run the 5 commercials, right?
Yeah.
And then don't even show the kickoff. If it's a touchback,
yeah.
I don't need to see it.
Yeah.
Because I don't want to see a touchback and then go to 5 more commercials.
Yeah,
fuck that.
I hate that. After every
right?
kick, they
so
go to
So if it's a touchback, run the other 3 freaking commercials and then come back to live action.
No, I'm with you.
If the guy runs it back or it's a good play, then come back, show it, and go to commercials.
I'm with you on that, bro.
But this coming back, so I can see a guy kick the ball 20 yards out of the end zone and then go for 4 more commercials, that's what's killing your ratings.
Yep.
That's why people aren't watching, because it's effing boring.
Yep. Thank God for Red Zone.
It's boring.
Thank God
how about
for Red
test
Zone.
Drive during preseason, a new game where they don't have officials on the field. They're in the booth watching all of the stuff they can do now. If you haven't seen this in baseball, they've been complaining about this, and guy says, he goes, the pitch count is more accurate on the screen than the guy observing it live.
Yeah, with the little box, you mean, that they throw the pitches in?
They can actually judge that better. And he says, and the game goes a lot faster with a lot less
stuff.
What
do you do with base runners? With like an out at second or something? Do you...
Same thing. So
you basically turn to the big screen to find out if it's an out or not.
Yeah. And they're
That's interesting.
They said they did it with one guy on the field. They put a thing in his ear, and then he doesn't watch the pitch. He's watching to make sure something else isn't going on. But he said they're telling him. Ball. Strike.
I think for baseball, it'll eventually get to that because it is.
I don't think it'll ever get there. But then
you don't think so?
I think
for just buying the play, I think you have to have umpires somewhat in the field because there's a lot of bang-bang plays, catches like that, and the game would get dragged on if you just looked at a screen after every single play.
Well, my problem is they don't get it right. Case in point, tonight.
Well, we'll take the call. We got
Gonzalez.
Oh, Dizzy?
Gonzalez was safe.
Yeah, he was safe.
So even if there's replay, doesn't mean they're getting the call right.
Yeah. Well, how's our number 2 black guy doing? What's going on?
Oh.
You know, I'm feeling like a second-class citizen, but that's okay.
Wow.
What's up, gentlemen? How you guys doing?
What's going on, Odizzle? We're doing great, pretty good. We just blew away a lot of teams' hopes and dreams right now. A lot of fans by blowing up their team's chances. But we're about to get into our first couple games of Pigskin Pick'em. You want to join us?
Hey, give me a couple picks. I want to concur with Knocker. I think you're absolutely right, Knocker. The fact that you're showing touchback is just a complete waste of time.
Yes.
And then you go to 5 commercials, and then you go back and you call a play. The commercials are killing you, man. It drives me nuts. Like you said, don't even show the stupid kickoff if it's touchback.
Why do I need to see that? I don't need to see that. And I think you, to me, again, me personally, you get one timeout per half.
fit.
One?
One.
Wow.
Nah,
I don't like this. I don't like this. If you can't manage the clock with 12 minutes left in the quarter, you don't get a timeout. You take the 5-yard penalty because you were too stupid to get the playoff in 39 seconds. I'm sorry. Can't do it. I don't need that effing timeout. And then at the end of the half.
One's tough.
Yeah, I could go two.
That would change the end of the game.
Yeah.
That would change the end of a half. That would change a lot of things about football.
Yeah.
I would drop it down to two. But like you said, if you can't get the playoff in 40 seconds, you got something's wrong with you. You got to get your offenses in better position, and you got to play situational football much better.
Yeah,
so
you,
I just want to throw
you,
that
you've
out.
You've been
there.
Taking a couple too many long tokes there, Knocker. Just calm down. All right,
timeout, man. All right, I'm sick of timeouts.
All right, let's get into it, man. Pigskin Pick'em. Here we go. Week 7. Week 7, man. We're getting there already.
I know, man.
Moving God. All right, week 7 Pigskin Pick'ems. Here we go. Get into our leaderboard real quick. Your very own sports guru.
Oh, shut up.
Has made a valiant charge up. Yes, that is me right there that you see. I'll get to you. Not bad. Not bad.
I was in second.
Lady Dragon now leads at 61. Amanda, another woman. We have two women leading our Pigskin Pick'ems.
I understand that.
So it's 61-60. We have Big Monkey Dream. Wow, I don't even know want to go there. At 60. We got Wrigley as sitting there again at a tie. So we've got three people at 60. Our leader at 61. I am at 58, Knocker, after having the winningest week last week with 12 picks. At 58.
I'm
and
still,
our own Giants fan has moved ahead as well above Bud
What's
Knocker
up?
With
what?
58
What's
correct
up?
Picks.
I was what?
Yes, Bud
week.
Knocker has moved down to 57. Now trails both his sons in Pigskin Pick'em.
Yeah.
What do you think about that, Knocker?
I'm not worried about it, man.
Dude, week 4 was the best. Sure. Week 4 was amazing. Josh was like 28th out of all of them. It was hilarious.
Anyone ever tell you look like a penis with a little hat on?
Huh? I don't know. Anyone tell you
Visor.
That?
Huh? Visor. Visor on.
Hey, did anybody pick the Jags? I picked the Jags.
I picked the Jags. Jags, baby.
That's why I'm wondering how you picked 12 winners. I'm calling bullshit. I am.
Okay, go back and research.
I call bullshit on that.
Exactly. I think you went back after a couple of those games and changed your picks. I don't recall you calling three games different than me on the air last week.
Unless someone takes the time out to check, I didn't. All right, so next up here, Knocker. Next up, we're going to get to our games here as O-Dog joins us. Again, you can follow O-Dog. O-Dog, what's your Twitter?
At O-Dog WBKS1.
That's right, man. If you guys want any information on my show that I don't know, just follow him. He has it all. All right, Knocker, next up here. We've got it. Here we go. Throw me on some background. First game of the week, Thursday night football, a little NFC showdown.
Bears versus Packers.
It threw me up just a little bit there, and I thank you. Bears versus Packers here. Bears on the road against the Packers. Packers going down to my Cowboys last week, B-Knock. Packers now at home again. Again, on the short week, though, Aaron Rodgers just doesn't seem to be himself this season. Now without Eddie Lacy, that running game is going to be hampered. Still have a pretty good defense, though. Bears on the road. I know they've been playing better late, but I'm just not a believer in the Bears. I'm going Packers here at home.
Oh, you have to go Green Bay. As bad as Green Bay's playing, and I am not impressed with them at all. You have to. I mean,
Chicago's
going to
have one outstanding game, but this isn't going to
be it.
Yeah, this is not it. All right, so me and Knocker are going to go with the Packers. And Dan, what do you got here, Renee?
What place am I in, by the way?
You are, let's see, what you're on the second page almost.
I got 7 again last week.
Yeah,
wow.
What's
That's
the
a bad
oh,
week,
the best
bro.
Beaner, you're at 51.
I'm at 51.
Yeah.
Hopefully this helps.
Yeah. Brett Favre.
There we
Brett Favre.
How?
Brett Favre.
The same as us. You can't gain any ground.
What
the hell logic
wrong,
is that?
But
where'd you go to school?
But at least I'm not getting it wrong, though.
Not falling further behind?
Yeah.
You win if you don't get further behind. Okay, all right.
He's just going to stay in contention. All right. Daniel, what do you got, man? Giants fan.
Packers, but I would disagree that they don't have that good of a defense, man.
Their
the Cowboys did what other teams couldn't and took advantage of their two starting corners not playing, and you guys raped them.
We did. You're right. The Packers, though, at home are just a different team. So, our game, we're assuming the Packers. Next game up, this game is going to be played in London. Here we go.
Giants.
Whoa. Let me jump in there. I got some good information, Josh.
Damn.
You get about me?
Wow, it's pretty bad.
God, it's nice.
It just keeps getting worse.
You're just abusing him, Josh. Stop it.
Dude,
this is exactly why they're kneeling for the national anthem, right here.
That's exactly why they're kneeling down. What you're doing to my man, O-Dog.
I'm going
to
take a knee right now.
Black Lives Matter.
Taking a knee right now. Black opinions matter.
Dang,
black pigskin pickups matter.
If that's not right in the line, I don't know what is. Holy
O-Dog, go ahead, brother. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
So listen, over the last 12 starts, I saw a stat on Twitter. Brian Hoyer has better numbers than Aaron Rodgers, which is crazy. He's got a better completion percentage, better touchdown to interception ratio. He's got more yards. But with that said, I'm taking the Packers. Even though Aaron Rodgers doesn't look like himself, I still think the Packers overall are a better team.
Back that ass up. That was a back that ass up pick from O-Dog, if I've ever seen it. Here we go. Next up, again, this game will be played in London. So, again, set your alarm clocks early, early Sunday morning. Here we go.
Giants versus Rams.
Giants versus the Rams. The G-men go on the road against the Rams here, Knocker. Rams at home. Or not at home. Again, they're going to be in London. Both these teams, it's always a sloppy game when you go to London and play football. Literally, these games are almost impossible to watch because it's just bad. It's bad football. With that being said, I think that the Giants somehow, some way, find a way to win this game over the Rams. I think the Rams aren't as good as advertised. I know they came out and won about two or three there in a row, but I'm just not a believer in this team and the way that Jeff Fisher coaches it. I'm going to take the Giants in a very sloppy game over the Rams. What do you got, Knocker?
The problem with the Rams is three-fourths of their defensive line was hurt last week.
Yep.
All right? They're in a rough place as far as defense
besides
goes.
Besides Donald, that's basically the healthiest guy.
Donald's the only guy playing. Yeah. The other three starting defensive linemen all sat out last week.
Okay.
That's pretty much impossible to win.
Yep.
Right?
If you just let Eli sit down, you know, back in that pocket without a pass rush, you've got Cruz, you know, you've got Shepard, and you got Odell.
This is going to be the last time I pick the Rams.
Really? For me, I kind of ended like last week with I think 2 weeks ago.
Right.
But the Rams, I'm not buying it.
I'm
going
to go with them one more time to beat a Giants team that just isn't that good.
All right.
And plus, I like the sound effect.
All right, Renee, what do you got, man?
3-5-4-5
You went opposite your sound effect there.
Wow.
I did. All right, like it. Dan, what do you got here?
I'm going to take the Giants based on the fact that the time change is too much for the Rams. They're going to be getting up at 2 in the morning our time to get prepped for the game.
That's true.
I like it. Yeah. I like that. That's not seriously. You look at the Giants,
the
they're
sound
on a different.
As any other
they're a four-hour difference.
No joke. And the spread in this game is 3 favoring the Giants here. So that's how Vegas sees it. You're obviously Giants fan going with the Giants here. So, I just want to real quick. Were you happy that he proposed to the net, or how did you feel about that?
I hate it because they just assume because I'm a Giants fan, I like Odell. So anytime they're like, oh, what about Odell? Like, bro, I don't like him. I don't like him at all.
Okay, that's good. At least you're a level-headed guy.
Just beat Cruz. Just catch the ball, do your little arrow for a first down, and go back to the huddle, bro.
Yeah, you don't take your helmet off, run around the field like
that.
That
almost
cost
us the game. Yeah. I almost lost it.
Yeah, it is ridiculous. O-Dog, what do you got in this one, man? In London, Giants, Rams here.
Hey, listen, regarding that time change, the Rams actually left early, so they've been over there for a few more days than the Giants.
Okay.
So I'm not thinking the time change is going to hurt them as much as you would, you know, initially think. I'm with the, what was that, Cam who spoke about antics? Not Cam. Cam's a Denver fan. But the Odell Beckham Jr. antics are wearing thin quickly.
Yes.
Eli came out and made comments, basically threw him under the bus. The head coach threw him under the bus. That act is growing old, tired. I'm taking the Rams for the win.
Wow. All right. Split decision there. All right. Next up here.
I hate you.
Going to be a pretty, this is going to be actually a very interesting game to watch. Here we go.
Saints versus Chiefs.
It's just weird teams. NFC playing AFC here.
Wow.
Dome team going into the Chiefs here. Now, it's not too cold. If this game was played more in November, December, it'd be a lot rough for the Saints here. But again, the Saints coming off the win. Chiefs coming off against the Raiders. I cannot go against Andy Reid at home. The Chiefs look pretty legit on defense. They got Jamal Charles back running the ball. Alex Smith, man, you talk about this guy getting some revenge.
Mm-hmm.
With the way he was treated in San Francisco.
Mm-hmm.
I like the Chiefs at home here over the Saints. I think the home crowd has a lot to play. Breeze, especially not going to be able to audible at the line and stuff like that. I like the Chiefs here by about a touchdown, 10 points in this one. I think they're going to control the game pretty much for most of it.
I think it was a nice win for the Chiefs. I think it kind of turned their season, you know, from going totally down the drain.
Yeah.
Saints on the road, on grass, Arrowhead. Got to go with the Chiefs.
Go Chiefs. All right. What do you got here, Renee? I like it.
not been sued?
I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. I forget who called me or someone texted me last week and listened to the show. Like, you guys got really racist on the last show. Like, really? Is that the first time? Are we getting too offensive? I don't know. All right, Knocker. Let's keep it going here. Now, Knocker, our blackout game has moved.
Wait a minute.
What?
We're moving on. Did you ask these guys? Did you ask O-Dog? What the hell, bro?
Okay, I'm going to pick the Chiefs.
You got Chiefs?
And the reason you guys haven't been sued is they can't find you.
We only have two listeners and they don't give a shit.
Oh, my God. Fist bump for that. That's fucking well played. That's just so fantastic.
I got the Saints.
O-Dog, what do you got here? Chiefs?
Arrowhead's a tough place to win. I'm taking the Chiefs. I think Marcus Peters picked up another interception from Drew Brees. I'm taking the Chiefs at home.
Oh, my God. Dan, that was fucking funny.
Blackout, no dog. Really don't care.
Yeah,
so.
Blackout, no dog. That's fantastic. All right, Knock. Next up here we go, an AFC matchup. This could have a lot. Whoever wins this game, I'm going to call it right now. Whoever wins this game goes on and makes the playoffs. Whoever loses doesn't make the playoffs. Here we go.
Colts versus Titans.
Colts versus Titans here. Colts on the road against Titans. Titans coming off a pretty good couple weeks here is the way they're playing. The Colts coming off the rough loss, Knocker. Going to be an interesting one here. Colts, what do you got? Colts over Titans. I'm going to go Titans at home in this one.
As am
close
I.
Game.
As am I. They
are
got
you really?
Brewing down there.
All right, I like
it.
Vegas sees it 2.5-point spread favoring the Tennessee Titans.
I think
Titans.
That loss to the Texans was crushing. I really do.
All right, so we're both going Titans. O-Dog, I'll go to you next so I don't forget you. Titans, Colts, who you got?
Thank you, Josh. DeMarco Murray is looking like he did 2 years ago. So he's taking some of the pressure off of Marcus Mariota. I'm going Titans as well.
Are you with me, O-Dog? I said it early in the show. I don't know if you're listening. I'm so sick of Andrew Luck, man, in the press conferences covering for his teammates. Isn't it about time he comes out and says, you know what? It's not my fault. My O-line sucks. I'm sick of getting hit 10 times a game, and I don't have anybody running the football.
And I'm holding
He's
the ball.
He's getting beat up. He's getting beat up, and they have to do something. For a young guy, you can't let him suffer through that punishment.
Yes.
Otherwise, you're going to shorten his career.
Right. You know what this is reminding me of, Andrew Luck? This is reminding me of A, Archie Manning, and B, Jim Plunkett. What's happening to Andrew Luck?
Good comparison
in Indianapolis.
Good comparison right there. I like it. All right, Renee, what do you got? Titans, Colts.
Release the Kraken.
All right, release the Kraken. Dan, what Titans. Do you got? Titans, Colts here.
I'm gonna take the Colts.
You take the Colts. All right, on the road. Then. All right,
Titans. I like Mariota. I like Mariota a lot.
I like it a lot. All right, Knocker. This is gonna be an excellent game here. Next up here, we've got Dr. Robb's
Vikings versus. Eagles.
Vikings versus Eagles here. Vikings on the road. That defense continues to impress, and so does Bradford. Eagles getting a little bit of a wake-up call here for Wentz the last couple weeks. Kind of brought back down to earth here, but the Eagles at home, always tough to play. Vikings on the road here, Knocker. What do you got?
How do you pick against the Vikings? How do you pick against a team that's undefeated?
Minnesota.
Until they lose, how do you pick against
Minnesota favored by 2.5.
Yeah, I'm going there.
I'm
going
to go with the Vikings defense as well, man. I just think it's going to swallow up Wentz too much in this game. They know how to control the football. They know how to run the football. And Bradford, as much as I've complained, floppy sleeves, I've ragged on him more than anybody. I've got to give him credit, man. To come over for a team like that within a week, learn the playbook, and play the way you're playing, you deserve credit in the world, man. So I'm going to go with the Vikings here on the road to win by about 7 or 10 here. Knocker, I think Wentz throws a couple interceptions in this one, maybe
probably.
A fumble. O-Dog, what do you got? Eagles, Vikings.
Vikings defense. I'm riding with the Vikings all the way.
All right, I like it. What do you got here, Renee? Blowing the Vikings horn. Dan.
Vikings.
Giants fan. All right, we're sweeping the Vikings here. Next game, Knocker. Finally getting to it. Unless you live in Ohio, you ain't watching this game.
You better have the ticket. Because it's the blackout game of the week. Browns. Versus Bengals.
Browns and Bengals, baby.
Wow.
Just like Fox wanted.
My boy,
right,
Cody Kessler.
Your boy, Cody Kessler. He's playing too bad this season, man.
I gave you that statistic.
One thing I can say for all
Sunday
you Cleveland.
Sunday ticket isn't even showing this game. Damn.
under the red zone, it says, we will not be showing any highlights because there is none from this game.
We will be showing Laverne and Shirley reruns due to lack of interest.
As much as we rag on the Browns for years. Got to give them credit, man. They play with heart. Mm-hmm. That team actually plays.
They do.
They play and they play their butts off.
Browns on the road against the Bengals here, Knock. I've got to go with the Bengals. They're just the better team here, even though they're not playing very well right now. And you know what? Vegas is a 10-point spread in this, man. They're giving Bengals got to give up 10
like
points
10
in this
points.
One. I know she might take the Browns in those points.
I like the 10 points.
But to cover in a Pigskin Pick'em, I'm going Bengals.
That's a safe play.
Safe play? What do you think? Renee, so I used to run around this guy's house, dude.
Yeah,
I was
you
he used
love
to blast song,
that song.
I run around walking like an Egyptian, man.
In your tidy whities.
Yeah,
just
no,
like
literally,
the
in tidy whities going around the house. It's my around. Jam. It's my jam.
We call them tantarans growing up. Because you jump up, you're tantaran.
Your chonies. You're like, run around your chonies. Dan, what do you got?
Don't really care. I'd rather watch reruns of the Rockford Files.
Wow.
He's going to be watching Grey's Anatomy instead of this one. You going Bengals? You got to go Bengals at home, right?
You know what?
I don't give a fuck.
Because Cody, yeah, I think so.
Go
yeah.
All right. What are you going to
do? I got Browns.
You got Browns.
Yeah,
the
just
upset?
Okay. A, I gave you that statistic.
Yeah.
Cody Kessler has the highest quarterback rating out of any Browns quarterback since 1992.
Okay, that just puts it in the worst in the NFL.
Yeah, he's got
that really
well, yeah.
doesn't say
well, yeah.
much.
But like he said, that
top
team plays
the bottom.
With heart.
Right?
And Cody Kessler, I've just been, I don't know right? why, just I been said, interested because he's a USC guy. He's got a lot of emotional stuff pushing him forward. So I don't know. I mean, you can't always pick the favorite team, right?
Right, you
so,
got to make him some ground. Yeah. And who knows, the Browns could come
and
out and surprise.
That's like the one
never know, man.
At the Braille Institute, right?
Yeah.
He's got it all going.
That just makes him the
cool
best
guy.
Of the shittiest.
He's the cool guy on campus. All right. O-Dog, what do you got, Bengals, Browns?
I'm going to ride with you guys on the Bengals at home.
All right, let's
I
get
think
two.
That's a smart play.
All right, let's get to two more before we get to break here. Next game up here.
Redskins versus Lions.
Redskins versus Lions.
It's a hard one.
This is a hard game.
That's a hard game.
The Redskins play surprisingly pretty good football. I mean, their defense.
And the Lions are on the up.
And the Lions are they're somewhere right there where you don't know what you're going to get week in and week out. Redskins on the road. Josh Norman, that defense, I think they're going to play big dividends in this game against Stafford. I'm going to take Redskins on the road here against the Lions in a trashy, close game. But I'm going to go Redskins on the road. Knock, what do you got?
Big win for the Lions last week, though it was, you know, against the Rams. Still is a big win. Matthew yep. Stafford is putting up some numbers this year, even without Megatron. They've got some pretty average players.
This is so sad.
That are
setting
playing,
up for a back that ass up.
That are playing. You know, Theo Riddick, I think. Theo Riddick's having a really good year. I think they got a lot of things going on. They've gotten
that
rid of,
being said.
They've gotten rid of the trash. The Ndamukong Suh's gone. McFairley's gone. A lot of the problems. I am going to go with Los Leones.
Really?
At home.
Wow.
Yes,
that
I'm
was
not going to back
was,
that
Yeah,
ass
that
up.
Was a total set of back that ass answer. Totally. With that being said.
With that being said, I'm going Redskins all the way. All
right, you going Redskins?
Courage. Courage.
All right.
Put him up.
All right. Dan?
Redskins,
all right.
You like that?
Los Leones for Daniel. All right, what do you got here, O-Dog?
Los Leones.
All right, the Lions.
That's what I'm talking about.
All right, and Vegas has this at a 1.5-point spread favoring Detroit.
That's just because they're home team.
Yeah, it is home
right?
team. That's
and they're not even
why.
Giving them the full three. That's how crappy this game is. They're not even giving them the full three
we'll
being
give,
at home.
We'll give you half. All right, Knocker, last game here. We've got a pretty good one here. A lot of offense going to be going on this one.
Raiders versus Jaguars.
Raiders versus the Jags here.
Wow.
Raiders coming off the bad loss at home against the Chiefs. Jaguars coming off the win there. The Jags have put two wins, I believe, together back-to-back here. Jags at home are always a little tough. Raiders, again, that East Coast traveling, or that West Coast traveling to the East, always tough. The Raiders, I can't get a grasp on the Raiders right
no.
now. I can't. I want to believe they're for real, but then they just throw up stinkers like usual. Same thing with the Jags. You win a couple, you're like, all right. Kind of turned around. Oh, I don't know. But that being said, I am going with the Raiders. And this one on the road. Knocked. They've been a better road team this year than home. I'm going to go with the Raiders.
You know what? That loss last week, it's got to hurt. That one's got to hurt. There's some internal things going on. I have some inside information. There's some internal things going on the Raiders.
Oh, with the Raiders?
Yeah.
Okay, you got some insider info going
yeah.
on? All right.
So I am going to go.
I know, it's so tough. This one is, this is right? A, this is that 50-50 game, like where you can gain a point or lose one.
I'm going with the ugliest uniforms in the NFL, them gold things that the Jaguars wear. I'm going to go with the Jaguars.
Going with the Jags at home. All right, Renee.
I told you talking shit about the Raiders.
Oh, stabbing the same Raiders, the thing.
Go Raiders.
That is so wrong.
And then the cap
after
at the
we
end.
Stab, we just cap them right. Finish them off. What do you got, Dan?
I think after last week with the Raiders, they're going to be pissed off enough to come back.
Me too.
And
for
take
some
this,
reason,
take
yeah.
this game.
All Me right. too. I'm with you, Dan. Raiders. What do you got, Giants Raiders. Fan? You go Raiders. All right, O-Dizzle. What do you got, man?
Can you guys tell me, is Derek Carr good or not? Because I can't figure
yes.
it out.
Yes, Derek yes, Carr is good. Yes. Yes, he
okay.
is.
Because
yes.
last week he put up a clunker and got me only
yeah,
14
okay.
points
but
in my fantasy.
I know. No, O-Dog, I got him on.
I love how fantasy always comes in.
O-Dog, I got him on three different teams, man. I was disappointed. But now look, last week, if you look at the game, man, the Chiefs and Andy Reid are one of the best teams in all the NFL off a bye. You got to give him credit, man. I mean, the Chiefs had 2 weeks to prepare for Derek Carr, man. So I think you got to take that game with a grain of salt.
They have been playing better on the road than at home. I'm going to go out on a limb. I'm going to take the Raiders going into Jacksonville, even though it's on West East, and they're basically playing at 10 a.m., but I'm taking the Raiders and Derek Carr.
All right, buddy. Hey, O-Dog, man, good talking to you. You know we love you. You're part of the family here. Again, you ever come out here, man, we got to have you back out here. It was a great time, so get out here real soon.
Absolutely, man. I appreciate it. You know I love being with you guys and hanging talking sports with you, and you know I'll be out there in April, man.
Hey,
for the golf tournament.
I'm almost tempted to put like an O-Dog ticket fair. Like, I want to pay for him to come down here.
Right, we'll take a fund.
Yeah, like I'm almost
send
ready
O-Dog
to do
out
that.
Here.
Yeah, one O-Dog down.
Hey, O-Dog,
man.
Send number two.
I'm gonna go. I'm gonna go with the premature shot of the week for the Scarlet Knights throwing up a big 7 this week.
All right.
Yes, they got on the board, baby. Got on the board.
That hurts,
Knocker. That hurts. Now, they've only been outscored 175
so
to
now
7 in 3
in
games.
In 3 games, they're averaging 2.3 points a game? Yes. All right. Yes. They're averaging a safety a game.
That's just me. You build me up, and then you tear me down. That is so mean.
That's what we do to the black man in America. We build you up, you break you down.
Hey, I'm married. I'm just built that way, baby. 35 years of marriage will do that to you.
Hey, O-Dog, give your radio show a shout-out, man. Where you at?
We're on Tuesday night. We're called In the Game. We're at WBKS1.com, 9 p.m. every Tuesday, East Coast time. O-Dog, Mr. Keep It Real, Chill, Ghost, and Coach B. We do try to do it as well as you guys do it, so keep up the great work, and I'll continue watching, man. I love the show.
You
know that.
Yeah, hey, guys. Say hi to the wifey for us, man. She's a lovely lady.
Absolutely,
say hi to us.
Man.
I appreciate you letting
her. I will tell her.
Yeah, thank you for letting you get on the line with us. So, all right, guys.
Thank you, brother. I appreciate that.
All right, you have a good one. When we get back, guys,
you too.
We've got the rest of our Pigskin Pick'ems coming up. We've got Knocker's Song of the Week here right now. And also, we get back, Knocker. Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, their inductees came out this year. Got the list. Want to kind of go over it, get your feel for it, back and forth, who should be in, who should be out real quick. Then we'll get back to our Pigskin Pick'ems. Knocker has been in Fuego with his college picks. They give you some more winners.
That's pretty good.
Some more winners. We got Because You Had a Bad Day also coming up. But right now, it's everyone's favorite part of the show, Knock. It's your song of the week. What
That's
do you
right.
got
hey,
this
you know,
week?
You know, again, I've got this thing for the first hit for certain bands. To me, it's just like kind of their best song. I mean, you know, they make good songs after it, but this is the one that put them on the map.
Right.
This song put U2 on the map. This is a song that was described by an LA DJ. I'm not sure if it was Bob Coburn or if it was Uncle Joe Benson on KLOS.
Okay, KLOS, yeah.
The iconic radio station that Heidi and Frank are on. Yeah. Heidi Frosty and Frank now.
Yeah.
But anyway, this is the kind of song that if you were at a party, picture yourself being at a party and this song comes on in the background and you've never heard this song before.
Start it up, Renee. Start
all right?
It
you've
up.
Never heard this song before, and at the end of it, you go, who the hell was that? Because that kicked ass. This is I Will Follow by U2.
All right. We're back.
I was the
Sportscast Live here on a Wednesday. Thank our sponsors again, Fireman's Brew and JuicyWhip.com. Again, make sure you guys spread the word, tell a friend, check us on iTunes, iHeartRadio, Stitcher Radio, and our SoundCloud channel. Just search Sportscast anywhere, basically, you can find us. Get a t-shirt today and support the show at our Sportscast store at SportscastLife.com, where all the stories, trending videos, and hottest news from around the league of a world of sports will be at. So check us out at SportscastLife.com. Right now, we are going to get to Shot of the Week Award. This is where we give a shot or a shit. If you want to shit on someone, you can also do that. If you had a good week, you got married, had a baby, got laid, your sports team won, you won a poker game, doesn't matter. You give a shot to someone. Call in the show at 626-208-9040. Yes, it sounds like I memorized the number, but I do not know what it is still. You can tweet us at sportscast_THN. I'll throw it to you, Renee, first as Knocker gets in the mood here. So here we go. What do you got?
Shot of the week goes out to the Cleveland Indians for going to the World Series.
Yes.
It's been a while for them, actually. They've been horrible for years.
Really bad.
The last time.
What, Manny Ramirez days back then?
I think the Kenny Lofton
days. Albert Bell?
Yeah, Albert Bell, Kenny Lofton, Manny Ramirez, those days.
I was a big Kenny Lofton fan, man. Kenny Lofton was cool. I liked the guy.
Yeah, he was on the Dodgers for a couple years.
Was David Justice on that team?
Right, I think so. Yeah, Dave Justice was on that team. Yeah, so shot to them.
Yeah, shot to them.
Yep. Shot to the Dodgers shutting out the Cubs in two consecutive games.
They're losing game four, but it's okay.
Yeah, this is going to go game seven.
Yeah,
so.
It's going to go. You called it game seven. It's going to go. So, all right, good shots up there. I'll throw it to you two first before I get to mine. Dan Cardona, what do you got?
Kowski from...
The Patriots?
Patriots. 167
yards. Yeah.
From your tight end?
Yeah, I know.
Holy cow.
And just trying to take on the whole Bengals team and fight them. I got to give him credit for that, man.
No.
Fantastic. All right, Gronky, for you.
I think I played Bennett then.
Dan, what do you got? I know you did. Giants fan?
My shot of the week is to myself because in 5 weeks I'll be done with college forever.
Yeah.
You aced the philosophy and calculus test this
week,
right?
Oh, my God, yeah. I'm going to blow my brains out.
Hey, and we need to talk about these automatic payments coming out of my checking account for your video games.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, we're going to have to talk about this a little bit later.
What are you talking about, man?
Is that PayPal?
I thought PayPal was free.
Yeah, no. Free to you. It's free to you.
You're the pal.
Right?
Yeah, you're the pal.
Hey, pay a pal.
You're the pal.
That's funny.
You're the pal, Pops. All right.
Wow.
Pops, I'll go to you, Shot of the Week. What do you got? I'll go last here. What do you got here?
Shot of the Well, I know what my shit of the week's going to Stephen A. Smith once again. Making all kinds of excuses for Cam Newton's behavior. Guy asks him a simple question. He goes on a rant that doesn't answer the question.
Yeah.
I just don't understand.
You're a douche.
You know?
I got you. He's a douche.
Shot of the week. I had one on the tip of my tongue.
Renee,
here,
throw the layout. Throw the layout with the number on it so
you
can see it there.
You know what?
No, it's okay. Go ahead. Just keep going.
I'm
going
to go with Brock Osweiler.
No, you should have a single one. The one on the far right.
No,
far
Dad.
Right.
Dad, we said right. Shot of the week.
That one there.
No, I am.
Just kidding.
I'm going to give him Shot of the Week.
Yeah, that one.
He had a chance to fold. Right? They were down by 14 points against their arch rival, the Colts.
Yeah.
Not that the Colts are that great, but they were still down 14 late in the fourth quarter. This was his chance to you know, suck it up and become the quarterback of the Houston Texans, or his chance to fold and throw an interception that loses the game.
Okay.
He brought them back through a three-play drive to get them within seven. They got the ball back. Again, he threw the touchdown to tie the score, and then they win it in overtime. He nutted up, man. Say what you will, but and you know the competition probably wasn't against. He could have probably done it against the Patriots, but he did it. He's now that team's official quarterback. They believe in him, and you know that's just a good feeling to have if you're a quarterback when you finally get over the hump and the team buys into you.
Yeah.
And I think that's what's happened with the Texans now, and I think good things are going to happen. But for just that 1 week, if you're asking for 1 week, I'm going to give it to him.
Okay. All right. Not bad. I've got a couple here. My first one goes to this man.
This kid is a gamer. He's a baller. He's a playmaker. And a shot caller.
In case you didn't know,
I got T-Bone. He shattered the mold. And all he does is win. All he does is win game.
Alert. Tim Tebow got his first hit in the fall league. He is now 1 for 16, people. 1 for 16.
Nice.
All right, but that's
nice.
A good
in today's major right? leagues, that'll get him 5 a year.
That'll get him
$5 million
a year.
There we
go. That's what I'd like to see. All right, next up here, B-Knock. I got to give a shout out to Peter Griffin and the Family Guy family for this spoof that they did on the Trump bus. It's fantastic. If you haven't heard it, here we go.
For letting me ride on a bus with you. Hey, you want to have some locker room talk?
I moved on her, actually.
Whoa, that's not locker room talk. I meant like good play, good pass, like that kind of thing.
I moved on her, and I failed. I'll admit it.
Well, as long as you didn't try to fuck her and she was single.
I did try and fuck her. She was married.
Oh, you're awesome. Hey, you ever thought of being president?
And I moved on her very heavily. In fact, I took her out furniture shopping.
Ah, sweet move. Was it Levitt's?
She wanted to get some furniture. I said, I'll show you where they have some nice furniture.
Levitt's.
But I couldn't get there, and she was married. And all of a sudden, I see her. She's now got the big phony tits and everything. She's totally changed her look.
Well, it is 2005. Everything's changing. Which reminds me, I have an idea for this thing called Twitter, where crazy people can bash ladies and minorities at 3 a.m.
She's your girl's hot as shit in the purple.
Oh, also Uber. I invented it, if you're listening to this in the future.
I gotta use some Tic Tacs just in case I start kissing her.
That's the cheapest breath mint. I thought you were a billionaire.
You know, I'm automatically attracted to beautiful. I just start kissing them. It's like a magnet. You just kiss. I don't even wait. And when you're a star, they let you do it. You can do anything.
Whatever you want.
What, like grab them by the hand?
Grab them by the pussy.
Oh, my.
This is too much good stuff right there.
God bless America.
So God
man.
Bless that.
Just God bless America.
And Peter Griffin, so you get my other shot now. Now, Knock, before we finish off the shots, I got to give a shot of the week here for the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. They're going to be inducting some artists into the Hall of Fame.
Five artists, right?
Now, we have a list, though. Okay, I'm going to run through them. Just give me a yay or nay real quick as we run through the list. Pearl Jam.
Yes.
Yeah.
Right, of course.
Yeah.
Tupac?
No.
Yeah.
You know
I'm
what?
With yeah too, right? But even though it's rock and roll,
my problem is
we'll leave that out.
Everybody's getting stuck with the name rock and roll.
Right.
I would prefer it to be the music.
Music
Hall of Fame.
Hall of Fame. Me too. All yeah. Right.
You know,
yeah.
I would because it's to say, well, rap's not part of rock and roll. Well, you know, and yes, they sample, but you know what? It's still if you're gonna do that, then you can't count the Rolling Stones in because they're rhythm and blues.
Yeah.
They're white, but they play rhythm and blues.
Right.
Right? I mean, if you're going to get that picky.
Bob Dylan's not freaking right? rock and roll. You got Bob Dylan in there.
I mean, the best, to be the best at what you do should get you in the Hall of Fame.
Right.
And Tupac and Biggie were the best at what they did. NWA, right?
Right. What about Alanis Morissette?
No.
Temple,
he had two songs.
Temple the Dog for before Pearl Jam was Pearl Jam?
No.
No, because they had one album.
Yeah,
I
they
think.
Had one
album.
All right.
Yeah.
What about Tori Amos?
No.
No.
Too depressing. Paul Weller?
No.
No. The Cranberries.
What? One song.
There's a band called
one
The Cranberries?
From Karate Kid 3.
Hey, you know who The Cranberries are?
The Cranberries.
I mean, I love the song.
From the guy who's smoking a...
How do you go out on stage
like, we are The Cranberries, yeah!
They had the one song from Karate Kid 2 or 3, and that was a great song. It's a really good song. But no. I mean, you got to give me... Give me something more than one or two.
You don't
songs.
Know who the Cranberries are, Daniel. You don't know this song right here, Daniel?
Yeah, I know this song.
No, the other one. Not even this one. It's the
What's
other
the
one.
Linger? This one?
No.
What? What?
That's Linger. One from Karate Kid.
I don't know which one you're talking about. Karate
it's because Josh is just on the top five. He's just got top
five.
Dude,
I actually know songs that people know. All right, next up here, Apex Twins. Do you know who they are?
I'm sorry, but the song I'm speaking of was their biggest hit. So you can just
wait, are you talking about that one song that goes, I am the man who must fight for
That's
your...
That's Pizza Terra, you weenie.
I know who you're talking about.
Yeah,
no.
Weenie.
No, I didn't know.
He's going
what are you fucking talking about? Dude, I grew up with those movies.
That is now my
movies.
Shot of the week.
I know those movies.
It's the movie with
front
the,
to back.
It's the movie with the chick in it.
Oh, my God.
That's Karate Kid 3, right? The one with the chick in it.
No, it's
Karate Kid. Starring the chick?
Yeah.
The no, that was like the
like
second
four.
The one.
Yeah, it's one. It's from that one. The one that the chick
okay.
was starring in.
I don't
in.
Even count that one.
Yeah,
from
we don't
one.
Count
But it's
those.
A really good song.
One. All right, what
but
about
no, they don't believe
what about Prodigy?
Know who they are?
No.
You know who Prodigy is? Yeah, they're iffy. Oh, what about The Cure?
Yes.
Out of all that you just named, yes.
Okay, well, what about Smashing Pumpkins?
Yes.
Wow.
Come on, Smashing Pumpkins, you got to put in there.
Three songs.
No
way. Three
good
songs. No. All right, about Soundgarden?
No.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm not. Hole?
No.
Okay, what about Tom Petty?
Yes, of course.
Bon Jovi?
Yes.
Oh,
yes.
Okay, Janet Jackson?
No.
No?
I say yes for Janet.
Well,
wait.
Yeah, because for her,
she had that huge album Rhythm Nation in the
90s. Beyonce before Beyonce, and she put out just a whole string of really, really good songs.
Knocker, why did you hesitate on Jovi?
Yeah, why are you hesitating on Jovi?
I saw that.
You're like one of the biggest Jovi dudes.
I know, but to me, it's like the way they give away the stars on the Hollywood Walk of Fame now. I mean, you could be the trash guy and get a star.
Oh. How is that not? Come on.
Runaway.
That's got to be in the Hall of Fame.
Runaway is his best song.
They deserve to be in it.
All right, next up, what about Chaka Khan?
No, two songs.
Mariah Carey?
Yes, but God, that hurts me to say.
I mean, there's no doubt
the amount of singles and millions of records she's sold.
What about Sting?
Of course. Yes.
All right, The Cars?
Yes. Man, they had some good stuff in the 80s. I like The Cars.
Hard to pull the trigger on that one.
That's an iffy for you guys?
Yeah.
What about Kylie Minogue?
Who?
Kylie Minogue? You don't know who Kylie Minogue is? Knocker, are you serious?
Kylie Minogue, first of all. Kylie Minogue, not it.
You don't know this song.
She is silent. Be there in your
arms. Won't you stay? Oh my God, you can't. Won't you stay?
The fact that they that song can make you do that.
One song, man.
I gotta go now.
All right, last one's here. Alice in Chains?
Yes.
No.
No.
Not enough.
Really?
Not enough material, man.
What about the Moody Blues?
Oh, of course.
Yes.
Jethro Tull?
Yes.
Yes.
All right, what about Fish?
I don't even know anything
they've
done. I'd
say yes.
Yeah? All right, don't say
yes. I'll go with
Chabbies will come out. All right, so that's what I want to get through. So the shot of the week for all those rock and roll, I guess, inductees or who could be getting in. So you got anything? Oh, for Proto wants a shot because his wife's going to have a baby in 6 weeks.
All right.
Shout out to Proto's
little
wife.
Little Ginger.
And then just a shout out for my boy Project Roto will be on the show next week. So Nick will be on the show next week. So.
All right.
All right, guys, so let's get the shot song ready. Let's load up the shots. Shots. Here we go. Shots. 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 Shots.
Shots. Shots. Shots. Shots. Shots. Shots. Shots.
Shots. Shots. Shots.
Shots. Shots. Why wasn't the girl from Oh Mickey, you're so fine, you're so fine? Why wouldn't she have?
Oh Mick, what is that? What's
Oh Mickey?
Yeah, who is that though? Well, you got to know the name. I can get you a song. Give me the name.
None of you know.
I know the song.
I know the song.
Yeah, I don't know who's singing.
Tony Basil. I mean, you know, if Nicki Minaj is on there, why isn't Tony Basil?
Tony Basil.
Nicki Minaj is on
there. There you go. Tony Basil.
No, what's her name? Minogue.
Oh God, I was like, oh.
Oh Mickey, you're so fine.
Kylie Minogue, how many does she have?
Exactly.
You know, if you go over that,
Knocker,
over her.
You can't tell me you get in the same mood that we just heard that song when this song comes on.
That is baby making stuff. That's ecstasy.
It's like the early days of synthesizers, man.
It's so great. That's me and your mom on ecstasy, sweating to strobe lights right there, bro.
Fuck just happened right now?
I don't know, dude. I heard ecstasy, strobes.
I'm out.
Sweating.
I'm out. I'm just dying.
Have you had a finger up your ass?
I don't know, but my mother apparently has an ecstasy.
Hey,
all right. Next up, here we go. All right, next up, let's get. Football. We're talking football.
Wow. That's like a live.
Imagine if Mama had the live viewing party with the priest inside right now, we'd be screwed.
We'd be
then there was Father Don.
Yeah, Father Don. Yeah.
That is like a lifetime of nightmares.
Oh,
right
good
there.
God. You're going to be outside right now with crosses,
Josh,
and candles.
Next time I'll bring my things you cannot unsee or unhear list.
Things you can't take back.
Things you cannot unsee.
Shout out to my girlfriend who's behind home plate at the Dodgers game right now.
Is she really?
Five rows back.
Nice.
Can we see her on TV?
You should be able to.
Nice. All right.
Just look for the double D.
Tell her to flash.
Oh, what? She look for the double D's? Is that what she's...
Tell her to flash.
All right.
Is she dating someone on the team?
Wow. I don't know. Maybe we can arrange something.
I think she's going into pitch. They're down 10-2.
Right?
All right. Throw out some background. Let's finish out the rest of our Pigskin Pick'ems.
All the runs the Cubs are going to score this entire series. So all
right. Let's hope. Yep. All right, Knock. Here we go. Next game up here at Fish Shop Pigskin Pick'ems, Week 7. Pretty good game here. Here we go.
Bills.
Oh, turn me up a little bit here. It might be mine. All right, here we go.
Bills versus Dolphins.
Bills versus Dolphins here, Knocker. Bills coming off the win last week. I think they won 3 or 4 in a row now.
4 in a row now.
Yeah, Dolphins coming off the win against the Steelers here. Knocker. Bills on the road is this typical letdown game for the Dolphins. I see it as when I'm going to take the Bills on the road here over the Dolphins. What do you got?
Let's go, Buffalo.
3-point spread favoring Buffalo. Renee, you going to go with the Bills or the Dolphins? All right, Bills.
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 Bills, and for fantasy owners, LeSean McCoy had a tight hamstring today. So
yeah, I know. We brought that. Yeah, he killed my
little hammy.
Yeah,
little hammy.
All right, next game up here. So we're all going to sweep with the Bills. Next game.
Ravens versus Jets.
Ravens versus the
God,
Jets
that's
here.
Not a blackout game?
No, the Cleveland Cincy game's the blackout game, man. Ravens
the
versus
Ravens
Jets.
Just, you don't know. Have they even played this season?
Who,
seriously,
Ravens?
Are they the most just un?
Well, they're 3-0. They've lost 3 in a row now. They're 3-3. Ravens on the road. Jets 1-5. Vegas has this as an even spread, so they don't even know who's going to win. I'm going to go with the Ravens. Again, it's Geno Smith. He's going to be starting for the Jets. Only reason I'm going with the Ravens here, I like Ravens over Jets.
After only scoring 3 points and costing me a $70 pool at work, the Jets can suck my
All right.
Well, now that is in-depth analysis you will not find on any other sports show.
You don't get that on
anywhere.
Center,
you don't
ever.
Get that Sports Center. Yeah. No. Nothing.
Nope.
Nothing. Fox Sports News. Scott Van Pelt. You won't get that in-depth analysis anywhere else but here.
Suck my balls. All right. What do you got? Renee?
I forgot what I was doing. Ravens,
Jets. Ravens. Jets or Ravens?
I forgot where I was at.
Are you going Jets?
Yeah, I'm going Jets.
All right. Dan?
This will be another blackout game of the week for me because I'll probably black out before it comes on.
Right?
I really don't care. I
blackout
really don't care on
the blackout alcohol game of the week. Yeah.
So right. Crow with the Raven.
You going with the Ravens? All right. Next game up here. This could have been
take
blackout.
The wife to breakfast.
There's a lot of horrible games. This could have been a blackout game, too.
Buccaneers versus 49ers.
Oh, God.
Should we just play it?
That's
again?
Worse than
you better have the
game.
Ticket. It's the blackout game.
Blackout game.
Seriously, that's worse. That's worse.
You think that's worse than the
Cleveland
Cincy?
Yes.
For fantasy, though, Mike Evans and
at least just Kaepernick's playing. You know, like,
does anybody have anybody on the 49ers in fantasy? Anybody?
Yeah, the running back.
Who?
What's his name? The running back. That's
Hyde?
About it. Yeah, Hyde. Carlos Hyde's about the only one anyone has.
Okay, that's 44 players. One guy on fantasy. Okay, we got two guys on the Bucks.
I got three guys.
I got their punter right out of 95 players. There's three playing fantasy this week, and that's not the blackout game?
It's not. It's not.
Look,
it
Tampa
is. We
Bay.
Have two of them. Tampa Bay's favored by two.
Tampa
in this
Bay's
week.
Got some
Tampa
offense.
Bay.
I'm actually going with the upset. Well, I guess it's upset. I'm going with the Niners at home. I'm going Niners. East Coast traveling West Coast. I'm going to go Kaepernick. Somehow gets it done in San Francisco. Somehow. Yep. That's how I went. Yep. Who's winning right now in pick-ups? This guy.
Who owes me $20?
Me.
This guy. This guy. What do you got, Renee?
Renee, the game's over, bro. Why are you watching, man?
Renee, they're down 10-2.
10-2 in the sixth.
You have to be loyal to your team. Anything can happen at any time, all right?
They're not even up.
Yeah.
If the Angels were in this position right here and it was 10-2, anything could happen.
Yeah.
Right? Would you guys be watching TV?
No, I'd be making my pick-ups.
Look out. Dude, you just got super trolly right there,
dude.
All right, what do you got in this one, Knock? Oh, you got Bucks?
Voice.
You got Bucks. Dan, you got Bucks or Niners?
I think I'm going to take the Niners in this one.
Yeah, me too.
They're due for something.
That's what I'm going with. What do you got? The Buccaneers. Are you going Bucks? This is going to be an excellent game here. Next one here.
Chargers versus Falcons.
Chargers, Falcons here. Chargers on the road against Falcons. Excellent. Falcons at home. -6.5, basically a 7-point spread favoring the Falcons here. Chargers, again, been playing with house money, I believe, last three or four games, sticking with games with the depleted injuries that they have. I'm going to go with the Falcons to win by about 10 to 14 in this one. I like Falcons at home.
Falcons by 14.
Okay. All right. What do you got, Renee? Falcons. Dan.
Falcons.
Falcons. Sweeping the Falcons here. All right. Next game up here. We've got what was going to be a good game until the injuries came down, but.
Patriots versus Steelers.
You got Landry Jones going with the Steelers. Patriots again with Brady. Just look almost unstoppable. I'm going to go with Patriots on the road over the Steelers. I believe it's a 7.5-point spread in Vegas here. Yeah, that's what it is.
Patriots.
Renee, Patriots going to cover this one or the Steelers?
It's such a lame drop. I need to work on that. It's so lame.
You should get Brady saying something.
Yeah, I will.
Yeah, something with Brady or something. Or like a bad Belichick quote or something.
No, I think you should do the Affleck and Matt Damon. Just take a clip out of that conversation.
Like a Patriot.
T-Bone. Dan, what do you got this one, man? Patriots.
Patriots.
Go Patriots.
I'm going with the GOAT.
You're going with the GOAT. All right, Patriots. It's going to be Sunday night football. Going to be a really good game here in the NFC. Is this team for real? Both these teams. We're going to see if they're for real tonight. Here we go.
Seahawks versus Cardinals.
Cardinals look like the team that we thought they'd expect last week. Cardinals can't, you know, yeah, Carson Palmer looked good. Exactly. They played the Jets.
Down.
Now the Seahawks, looks like they might have got a call gone their way at the end of that game. That was pass interference. I don't know what else you're going to call, but I think the Falcons got screwed. But the Seahawks pull out the win. Seahawks on the road against the Cardinals here, Knock. Seahawks are a different team when they leave that home field advantage here. 1.5-point spread favoring the Cardinals. I'm going to go and take those points. I'm going to take the Seahawks on the road.
Zona, baby. Carson Palmer all the way. Larry
Carson
Fitz.
Palmer,
Larry
all right. Fitz. Renee.
And my running back. I don't even know his name.
All right. He's going Seahawks. Dan.
Cardinals.
Go Cardinals.
Seahawks.
Seahawks.
And that call was on Sherman, right?
Yeah, it was on Sherman, yeah, at the end of the
What's
game.
My running back's name? David, what?
David Johnson. Yeah. David Johnson,
love
yeah.
him. Love that guy.
He's really good. Really good. Glad I picked
That's
him.
That's my favorite player
That's
on my team.
That's my favorite player What's on your his team. Name? All right, Knock. Here we go. Monday Night Football.
Monday Night Football. Texans versus Broncos.
Old Allsweiler Hard makes his one, trip wow. back to Denver here against the Broncos. Broncos been reeling of late. They're both 4-2 teams here. Spread is -7.5 favoring the Broncos here, so no respect
seven
to the
Texans. 7.5?
Yeah. Wow. And you know what? They're going to cover that. No problem. I'm going to take the Broncos big here over the Texans. I'm not impressed with the Texans offense at all.
Hey, the Broncos stumbled, lost, then they lost their coach. They had to play on a Thursday, so they've got 10 days to recoup and refigure this out. They're playing at home. You know the crowd is going to turn on Brock as bad yep. as he's ever been turned on before.
Yep, yep.
The Broncos are tough to beat at home. I'm going to go in a tight game and go with the Broncos.
All right, Renee. Like the Bronx, Dan?
Yeah, Broncos are tough to beat at home.
At home, I agree. What do you got?
Is Simeon still the quarterback?
No, he's not. Well, no. It could be back. We'll see, but they've got Paxton Lynch.
Nah,
going
I'm going
right
with
now.
The Texans.
All right, going with the Texans.
Nice. Yeah.
Texans I just think you go back in there and you're like, man, you guys couldn't trust me with the starting job. You guys
Damn.
Can go. You know?
All right. It's been our week 7 pickups, guys. We're going to get to break here. We're going to run maybe a little long. We've been running long lace last couple shows, but it's
no
okay.
Kidding,
we've
man.
Got plenty of coming up with the show next last half hour here. We got Knocker's NFL or college football picks. You do not want to miss them. He has been in fuego of late here, so stick around for that. Also, we've got because you had a bad day, you want to stick around for that. And we'll talk a little bit of baseball. Dodgers Cubbies. Looks like the series is going to be tied. Tied, right? They're up 10-2, yeah. right? There's no way they're coming back.
Gotta throw Kershaw tomorrow.
And the Indians are in, so we'll talk about that more a little bit, 20, 30 minutes when we get back here on the Sportscast. All the listeners taking out the time and all the callers. Again, you guys call the show 626-208-9040. And again, get your t-shirts today. Sportscast t-shirts at our Sportscast store. They're only $25 a piece. We got sweatshirts as well. So check them out today at sportscastlife.com. Knocker, want to give a shout out to my buddies. We play in a golf tournament next weekend, so I'm pretty excited about that.
Yeah, very nice.
You bailed out. Are you still going to the river?
Yeah, I'm going to the river.
You're going to the river?
Yeah.
Okay. I think Mark's going to play, Mark Cousins. So we got we got our foursome. Yeah.
Very nice.
So
that'd be a silver foursome.
And then I've got a pretty good day. Either way it goes, I've got good options. I'm either going golfing at Sierra Lakes at 2,
all right,
or I'm going to game 5 of the Dodgers Cups. So
tough choice.
I got tough choices tomorrow.
Right.
Tough life.
Don't you?
I know. Right?
And you're not paying for either one.
You don't have to make me look like a complete asshole. Right? My God. All right, Knock. Let's get real quick. Before we get to your picks, Knock, let's get to because you had a bad day. Can you play it for me here, Renee?
Because you had a bad day.
The uplifting part of the show where you think you're having a bad day, but these people are having a whole hell of a lot worse time.
Your life looks good compared to that.
B-Knock, this is under our trending videos section. Headline reads, Great White breaks open and enters a shark cage with a diver inside, B-Knock.
Yeah, boy, this was amazing.
Throw this up, Renee. Check this video out, man. This Great White literally breaks into the diver's shark cage, breaks through the side of it, and comes out the top, B-Knock. You're crapping your pants
That's
at that
amazing.
Point, right? You're crapping
no,
your
you're
pants.
No, you're not crapping your pants because your sphincter's so tight you couldn't get a freaking pinhead with a jackhammer up your butthole at that situation right there. There's no way.
That's why I don't get in the ocean, dude. I'm carne asada to the sharks. They're like, oh, look, a seal. Oh, he's brown.
And they call that a shark-proof cage.
Right?
I know, right?
Isn't that great?
What if you're like the tourists like that are just waiting to get in? Like, yeah, I'm not doing
that.
Can
I have my money back?
What'd you say? Curl up and just act like you're like a big whale turd?
Oh, yeah, he had a black wetsuit on, so I'm sure he's down at the bottom of the cage going just, I'm a turd, I'm a turd, I'm a turd. You don't want me. I'm not food. I'm a turd, I'm a turd, I'm a turd.
I'm whale poop.
All right.
He probably crapped himself, hopefully, in the fact that he did smell like poops. The
Absolutely.
Shark wouldn't eat him.
Jesus.
That's because he had a bad day right
That's
there.
That's a bad
so
day.
If you think you're having a bad day, imagine being the shark
you
cage.
Had a bad
imagine.
Day. Take
all right, now, Knocker.
Yes.
My mother's a beautiful woman. You married her because she's beautiful.
Yes.
Now, when you guys... before you got married, was she the type of chick that, oh, you can't see me unless I have all my makeup's on and my hair's done?
Pretty much.
Really?
Yeah.
She's still kind of like that way to now. Right? Like, she's still...
Not with me anymore, but with anybody else.
Yeah, okay, absolutely. She had to have her makeup done, yeah, right?
Absolutely.
Well, imagine if you're...
I go now. Oh, I don't know. What is that?
What is that? I don't know, but it's, let it play. It sounded cool.
I'm on some Asian porn tide. I'm tired.
All right. Headline reads, dude files for divorce from wife immediately after seeing her without makeup for the first time.
Damn.
That's a bad day. It says here the 34-year-old man, who didn't want to release his name, went swimming with his 28-year-old wife at the Almazar Beach in Dubai. So they, like, you know, they had their honeymoon there. He was reportedly horrified to see her features changed drastically after the water washed away her makeup.
God. How bad could it be?
Like, really?
Seriously, how bad could it be,
that's,
bro?
So he has filed from divorce. That is a bad, bad, a bad day.
Wow. That's a bad day.
There's no coming back from horse face.
There's not at
There's
all.
There's none.
Maybe every time he's with her, he was drunk. Why that time, face? You know? Yeah, exactly. Well, knock now. There's some men that don't.
I like it when you laugh at my stuff, Renee. I do.
There's some men that don't enjoy the toys in the bedroom, right, for the women. Sometimes you need to spice it up, right?
Well, sure, they get jealous.
But sometimes guys get a little too jealous, like this dude who was arrested after smashing his girlfriend's dildo to smithereens because she loved it more than me. Read the headline.
Wow, well.
Man, it says 33-year-old
Rich
Moore was arrested for criminal damage after going on a minor rampage while collecting his belongings from a house he shared with his now ex-girlfriend. After destroying her $240 sunglasses, he then took her vibrator and threw it and smashed it, Shane. She loved it more than me, and I bought it for her.
What?
Quote for quote says, I was fed up. She moved on to another fella pretty much straight away after I paid for her to go on a holiday vacation. I went to get my stuff, and I came across this glass piece, and I smashed it. Then I found this dildo. It just ripped my heart out. It was one of those bullet ones. She loved the dildo more than me. That's why I got humped for it.
Oh my God.
I bought it, and it cost me $36. The police told me I had broken the dildo and offered to pay her. And offered to pay for it to save us all going to court. But they weren't having it. I wanted to go to court with the teacher saying, save the dildos. But I've decided that probably wasn't the best idea. That's a bad day.
So the dildo costs more than her sunglasses.
Right? $24 sunglasses. Yeah, the dildo was 36. So the vibrating bullet was a little more.
Wow.
That's a bad day, though, right? Wouldn't you say?
Yeah, that's a bad day. But you know what? What kind of dick buys his girlfriend a glass dildo?
Yeah, really?
Like, where do you think she's headed with this, bro?
Yeah, really? Where
Why would she ask
going?
For it in the first place? Right?
Who knows, knocker?
I don't understand.
I don't understand. But you know what? We're going to understand.
And you're shocked.
We're going to understand your football picks.
All right, let's
pretty
do it,
damn
then.
Good. Here we go. We've got Knocker's college football picks of the week. He's been in fuego, people. So listen up. Here we go.
Yeah, I went 3-2 last week. Narrowly missed a 4-2 weekend. Boise sucked. But I won with USC. I won with Alabama. Yeah, I'm not sure what the other game was. Now, this week, you got some interesting schemes. You got BYU just coming off a win at home over Mississippi State from the mighty SEC.
Yeah.
Right? They actually stepped out of their state and lost the game. Shocking, right? BYU goes to Boise State. Boise State is coming off a game I think they played on Thursday, and now they're playing again on Saturday. Short turnaround for Boise State. Letdown game last week. They played Colorado State and just laid an egg. BYU is getting 7 points. Open at 9. BYU is getting 7. I like BYU in this. BYU has covered the spread pretty much every single week that they've played this year. I kind of like that. The Golden Knights of Army. Mark this. They haven't been a 19-point favorite since Doc Blanchard.
What?
Yeah, the Doc Blanchard days out in the 40s, man.
Wait, you're telling me they're favored by
almost three touchdowns. By 19 points over North Texas, and you know what? I think they cover.
I really see it there. 19.5 over-unders at 51.
Right? I really do think they cover.
All right.
Number 10, Wisconsin, up for an overtime loss
to
the Buckeyes at home at Kyle Field. They go to Iowa. This is a game that just reeks of upset. This game just stinks of upset.
3.5
The spread is 3.5 The spread opened at 3.5 for Iowa. I look for Iowa to win the game straight up.
Really? Letdown game for Wisconsin.
I think this is an extremely huge letdown game for Wisconsin to go on the road after throwing all their marbles at Ohio State and coming away with a loss.
Okay.
Interesting game here. Absolutely no respect for North Carolina State, who has played Clemson and Florida State. They upset Florida State. They played Clemson. They probably should have won that game. They're a 20-point dog at Louisville. I'm inclined to take those points. That's a lot
that
of points
pack
right now.
And Louisville at home's dangerous. That quarterback, though,
very dangerous.
And now to put it in fact, the NC State's played two pretty hard games. They played in that rainstorm
against Notre Dame. But Notre Dame is nothing this year.
Yeah, but North Carolina State's line, D line, is pretty amazing, and they also have a coach like Texas A&M that is strictly about how to strip the ball from every position.
So a lot of turnovers.
So turnovers. Yeah, in fact, I think Texas A&M is way up in the turnovers. And so is North Carolina State.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Big.
So I like NC State with those 20 points against Louisville. The Colorado Buffaloes, the most improved team, the team that if you'd have bet every week against the spread this year, you would probably be, there's seven games in, they'd probably be 6-1 against the spread with the Buffaloes. Uh-huh. They go to a decimated Stanford team, even though they won on the road at Notre Dame. They're playing without McCaffrey. There's not a whole lot of confidence going on there. I look for the Buffaloes to cover that 2.5-point spread.
I like that, too.
I
like it.
Illinois coming off that huge win over the Rutgers Charlotte Knights last week. The huge win. Illinois steps in to the Big House as a 36-point underdog. A week coming off a bye for Michigan. I think they cover those 36 points. The marquee game of the week, number 6 A&M at number 1 Alabama. How does the number 6 team be a 19-point underdog?
I don't understand it. It's because the SEC is overrated.
I don't touch this game. I think Bama covers, but if I'm betting, I think I'll go somewhere else on this.
Bama covers.
I think I go somewhere else on this. I don't know. I really don't know.
This is my parlay. A&M. I would take Texas A&M, North Carolina State as a parlay and bet it big.
Bet it big, all right.
Yeah, A&M has something with Alabama from the Manziel days and whatever. They play Alabama tough. So, again, this is one that I wouldn't bet, but Big Dan says parlay that with North Carolina State. Utah, the Utes go to UCLA. UCLA is a devastated football team right now. Their quarterback is hurt.
Bad.
They have no running game. Utah's got their running
back. How is UCLA
back
favored in this?
They're favored by 7. I take those points
way. Yeah, and the Utes give them so much trouble every single time they
play. Utah's coach. I forget his name. I love Utah's coach, though.
And I could make
Kyle Whittingham. Yeah, absolutely.
I can make this a lock, too, because every time I wear my Utes hat and send a picture to Pat Marshman, they beat him.
That's awesome. You got Oregon State going to number 5 Washington.
Yeah.
Opened at 29.
It's at 37.
That wasn't enough. It's moved 8 points.
That's insane.
8 points.
You stay away, right? You don't touch
I'm not going to bet, but just for fun, I think Washington covers. Ohio State goes to Happy Valley to play Penn State. They're a 19-point favorite. I think they covered that.
Okay.
Washington State goes to Arizona State. Arizona State is just a terrible football team right now. Arizona State gets 6.5 points. I don't think that's enough. I think Washington State's covered that. Mississippi State goes to Kentucky. Kentucky gets 3 points. Mississippi State will cover that. Arkansas goes to Auburn. Auburn is a 10-point favorite. I like Arkansas with the points on that one. Rutgers goes into Minnesota. It opened at 21. It's down to 17. Not sure why. I think Minnesota covers that one. Indiana at Northwestern. Over under 52.5. I like that to go over. Oklahoma State at Kansas. Kansas is a 23.5 point dog. I think Oklahoma State covers those 23.5. I will have my final 5 picks for you posted on Thursday.
Yep.
For you folks.
Is the USC not playing this week?
USC has a bye this week.
Bye. USC has a bye. Okay.
Yes.
All right. That's good stuff right there. Again, Knocker will have his 5 picks up at sportscastlife.com. So check those out. Knocker, we finished on good time today. I thought we were going to go over, but we finished up on pretty good time there. I like it. All right. Lastly here, finishing off with baseball here, Knocker. We got the Indians coming into the World Series.
Gosh.
We are going to have now the Dodgers.
Steamrolling.
Yeah, Dodgers or the Cubs. Now they're going to be tied 2-2 in the series here, Knock. We talked about a little bit on the show here and a little bit off the show.
Renee just found out, I guess Kershaw's not going to pitch in Game 5?
No, Maeda's pitching Game 5, and then more than likely they'll go to Kershaw in Game 6.
I'm not a fan of that at all, Knock. I think they should pitch him in Game 5, so at least you have him in relief somewhat in Game 7 with Kershaw. Because I think if you get the bats going with the Cubs right now, they just got broke out of that funk. Scored 10 runs tonight after not scoring any of the last two games?
Yeah,
you let him go up and you let him mash against Maeda again for another game. They get the momentum and go back to Chicago. I think if you're L.A., I think you got to pitch Kershaw in Game 5, man.
I've been thinking about this. I've been chewing on this and rolling around this in my mind because there's an argument on either side of this. I think if I'm Dave Roberts, I have to win tomorrow.
Yes.
I have to win tomorrow, and I have to win in a fashion that says, okay, you beat our ass 10-2, but we're still here, and we're still dominating.
Right.
I think rather than go down three games to two and have the Cubs beat Maeda, and depending on Kershaw and Hill, you have to win two games in Chicago. I don't like that scenario. I don't like having to win two games in Chicago. I think you pitch Kershaw tomorrow and you pitch Maeda in Game 6. And the way Hill dominated that lineup.
Throw him in Game 7.
The way Hill dominated that lineup, I think I like throwing Hill in Game 7, which is the way I would set this up.
Yep.
Tonight's game just got away with them. Got away from them.
Well, you weren't going to silence the Cubs' bats for that long.
Not forever.
You're not going to silence them, you know. And you got Rizzo finally hit the ball. You got Addison Russell, right? He finally got on the board with a home run. So, you know, I think you got to throw that shutdown guy tomorrow if you're the Dodgers, because if you go back down 3-2, you're not winning the series. It's just my opinion if you're the Dodgers.
No, I don't think you win two in a row in Chicago pitching Maeda and
right.
Hill. I think Maeda's going to get beat by this team whenever you throw him. So
I'm
putting all my money on Hill in Game 7
yep.
In this series. I think today's game, even though you know it's 10-2 and it got out of hand, I think a lot of this game turned on that replay, on that bullshit call.
That's a
on
big
the replay.
Call in the game.
It was a huge call at a huge time. If the Dodgers go
he
on
was
and
safe.
Score.
Adrian Gonzalez.
Yes.
You know.
If they score two or three runs that inning, the whole game.
Even just the psyche of lacking
exactly.
pitching at that point.
The whole
point.
Game changes on that one call.
Yep.
Not making excuses because they did obviously score 10 runs. But I think mentally the Dodgers were just, you know, how could such an obvious call
yeah.
be missed?
It did seem from there that it kind of fell apart a little bit, you know, unraveled
right.
for the Dodgers.
And it does
that.
Happen that way, you know.
Yeah.
So, Dan, what do you think? What are your thoughts on this?
No, I agree. I think you got to pitch tomorrow with Kershaw and get him in there, win the game, and be done with it. And
yep.
and
take
instead
your
of
chances
yeah,
in Chicago.
Yeah,
you
go
you know?
And you're trying to win on the road two games. Just too tough to
it's
do.
It's very yeah. tough to win two games on the road to finish
yeah.
the series.
I agree.
Huge
and
problem.
Hill, like you said, he'll pitch so good
yes.
that you know you're going to get him in 6 or 7. So, let's just get Kershaw. Let's know what I got before we get to Chicago,
basically.
I agree.
All
right, Renee, well, good luck to you, man.
Thank
good
you,
luck.
Man.
We'll yeah. see what happens tomorrow.
We'll what
it's going to be a good one.
I think
are you
I
going
still,
to the game?
No, I'm not.
I think Lester's
going
to pitch, right,
yeah.
for tomorrow? Game 5? Lester's got to be pitching.
So, yeah.
yeah.
I think they go back to the top of the rotation.
Yeah.
But, yeah, unfortunately, I'm not going to be at the game. I just dropped, like, a lot of money on getting tickets
yeah,
to
we heard your story
Roger
last
Waters from Pink Floyd.
Oh, are you going to the one
on?
Are you
yeah,
going to the one next summer?
Center, yeah,
yeah,
next summer.
Bastard.
Yeah.
That's going to be good.
Floyd is one of my favorite bands of all time, so this is, like, the closest I'll ever get to
yeah,
seeing
be
Pink
sweet,
Floyd
dude.
Live.
So that'd
nice.
Be a good time.
You know,
that'd
I've seen
good.
Roger Waters twice already. So
yeah, you just
my
saw
third
him
time.
A few months ago, right?
No, I saw him at the Wall Tour, and then I saw him, like, back in 2003.
Who did you see a few months ago that you saw?
David Gilmour.
Oh, David Gilmour.
Yeah, that was at the Bowl.
All right. Knock. Well, that's good. Let's have a good football weekend. Everyone be safe
yes.
out there. Enjoy yourselves. Halloween's going to be only a couple weeks away. So do you have a costume yet at all? Are you dressing up? No? I'm being Kylo Ren, just saying.
Are
no.
you?
Yeah, I'm going to be riding around a hoverboard. So it's going to be fantastic. I'm going to be chasing kids on a hoverboard with my lightsaber.
Nice. I'm going to be the Mexican.
I'm going to beat some clown asses on my hoverboard.
And go out late at night and steal those
hell
bags,
yeah,
those sacks
man.
Full of candy from
hell
the
yeah,
guys,
I'm
going right?
to grab him by the throat and be like, you talk to me. False.
I'm going to be the Mexican Justin Bieber and call myself Justin Beaner.
It's kind of like that.
Like that one?
I like it. I like it. All right, guys.
No,
we're
no,
back.
No, it's more like just a beaner.
Yeah, just, yeah.
Like
just
one,
a beaner.
Just
a beaner.
Just a beaner. Yeah, just a beaner. Well, guys, we'll be back next week. Love you guys all.